Welcome to Shotgun, everybody, and a happy 4th of July weekend.
Hey, don't worry about the shirt. We'll look pretty good, as a matter of fact. What a great hour we have this week. Besides the New Age Outlaws in action, we also history was made this week on Raw. We'll get to it a little bit later. This hour.
Shotgun, folks, we have a new World Wrestling Federation champion for the second time.
Wow.
In Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kane held the title for just over 24 hours. But it was a tumultuous 24 hours here in the World Wrestling Federation. We're going to talk all about it.
Well, what a title match that was, especially for Stone Cold Steve Austin. Smelled some disappointment, but it didn't last long.
Certainly did not. Plus, we'll talk all about what happened at the King of the Ring. We'll talk all about Ken Shamrock, the Hell in a Cell match with Undertaker and Mankind.
Whoa.
And, well, certainly a definitive statement on the 4th of July weekend from X-Pac.
Well, just that Hell in a Cell match, I think, was probably the best match I've ever seen. I mean, it's got to be said that Mankind is definitely one sick individual.
Oh, yeah, and he's very far from 100%. We'll talk about a little conversation I had with Mankind a little later on, up and over the top.
Whoa!
And Jesus is going to be able to match X-Pac's quickness in this contest. And also matching that little gesture.
Well, you can never sell any one of the Los Barricos short. X-Pac is a tremendous athlete, a tremendous wrestler in the WWF, but Jesus has proved time after time he can hold the best with anybody here.
What a war X-Pac had at the King of the Ring with Owen Hart. Both men practically unconscious on the canvas after what was a war. Leapfrog, great height, catches Jesus with the hip toss, and X-Pac looking to follow up on the veteran.
They just wanted to lay back, but X-Pac was having none of it. Good move by Jesus.
Jesus will have the weight and strength advantage in this contest as we look at the ninth wonder of the world, China, who I think has perhaps strength advantage over everyone here in the World Wrestling Federation. She was a factor in that X-Pac-Owen Hart match. And Tom, to me, it just seems that the nation feud with DX gets hotter and hotter as each week passes by.
I think with all the different personalities you have in DX as well as the nation, whoa! The Rock is the leader, and Hunter Hearst Helmsley as the leader of D-Generation X. There's no way it's going to mix. It's like oil and water, and X-Pac and the Road Dogg and B.A. Billy Gunn are good backup to have, in my opinion.
Well, they certainly are. We saw a King of Kings triple threat match, which was won by Ken Shamrock, the 1998 King of the Ring. Congratulations to the world's most dangerous man. Boy, nice high knee there coming in. Jesus flattens X-Pac
with a little help from Owen Hart.
Certainly, it was a victory for Ken Shamrock, and one in which I saw the DX and Nation feud just intensify more and more. And now look at this, double arm suplex,
whoa,
beautifully executed. X-Pac down on the canvas.
This is the first time I've seen X-Pac show a little ring rust since coming back. He's been in the ring maybe once or twice, and he looked pretty darn good. But right now, Jesus is looking good.
Lateral press, first one of the match. Tim White gets it to two, but that's all. The crowd firmly behind X-Pac. Certainly, you know, X-Pac took a tremendous amount of punishment in that King of the Ring matchup against Owen Hart. You got to wonder if there's any residual impact. China looking off to the outside. Other members of DX will be joining us later on in the hour. That's right, the New Age Outlaws in tag team action against Terry Funk and Dustin Runnels. I don't know if this building is going to be big enough to hold that tag team match.
It's going to be one I want to see for sure, but let's get back to X-Pac's injury for just a minute here. I think you can ask Stone Cold Steve Austin, anytime you receive a neck injury and you get back in the ring, it's like a chronic injury. It never goes away.
Well, certainly X-Pac is going to have to think about that. Plus, we also want to send out speedy recovery wishes to Jose Estrada of Los Barriquas, recovering from a neck injury himself. Suffered at the hands of Edge just a couple of weeks ago. Follows in, X-Pac greets Jesus with the boot. The spin kick right across the temple. And the adrenaline surge now, bringing X-Pac And this crowd once again on its feet. Hard right hand from X-Pac.
Well, he knows the rest of DX is watching in the back, and he definitely wants to make an impression like this.
Face first. Beautifully executed move. X-Pac decides not to go for the cover here. Instead, now back to Jesus, back into the corner.
The double chops.
A lot of animosity in the locker room, Tom. You know all about that. With this Brawl for All tournament that has begun, I mean, there are a lot of guys looking over each other's shoulders, and I don't think anybody can trust anyone else.
I know Bradshaw's looking over his shoulder, as is Mark Canterbury, and you know Merrill's going to be shaking in his boots with Blackman.
Look at that.
Bronco ride. I am really impressed with X-Pac since he's come back to the WWF.
Well, certainly has been very impressive. Goes for the same maneuver again, but this time, Jesus out of the way. Going after the back now. Owen Hart concentrated his attack at the King of the Ring on the lower back region of X-Pac. And Jesus following up in that same area. Is there a lingering injury? Perhaps there is. Will it affect the remainder of this contest? Jesus using his strength.
Nice.
Fall away slam. Lateral press doesn't hook the leg. Tim White only gets the two before X-Pac slides that shoulder out.
It looks like that neck is bothering me in this match, no doubt about it. But X-Pac is tough and he knows Helms is watching in the back.
Oh, man.
Nice chop by Jesus.
Irish whip, X-Pac, hard to the buckle. Jesus, shoulder first to the iron. And another spin kick, lifting Jesus off his feet. Hooks the leg, two, and he got it.
That was it.
That was a devastating jumping spin kick there.
And you know, Helmsley and the Road Dog and B.A. Billy are cheering for him in the back right now, too.
Shotgun is just getting underway. We got a lot of ground to cover. X-Pac, the winner. But folks, still to come on Shotgun, the New Age Outlaws will take out Terry Funk and Dustin Runnels.
And will Kane accept Stone Cold's rematch challenge for the WWF title? Oh, hell yeah!
Shotgun is brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT, the easy way to save.
And by WWF The Music, Volume 2, experience your favorite WWF original jams, now available in stores.
And by JVC Kaboombox, the portable music system with dual subwoofers and 52 watts of ring-shaking power. JVC Kaboombox, wrap it on!
Approaching the ring, weighing 271 pounds.
Perhaps looking bigger and better than ever, it's Farouk. A legend at Florida State University.
Mark Cooney.
Well, he's not at Florida State University now. He's got his problems with the nation, and he's got his problems with Marconi right now.
The youngster from Cleveland ducked his head, though, after getting a very quick start, and I think is going to feel Farouk's wrath. Pounding away, tremendously strong. Look at the shoulder definition. Look at the chest region.
Well, he's got a lot of anger, and he needs maybe an anger management course, although I think it's working to his advantage right now.
Farouk laying the badmouth now on Lou Marconi and anyone else who wants to jump in from behind. Certainly want to thank all of you who joined us at backstage at King of the Ring. What a success that was. The internet was buzzing, WWF.com. Myself and Tom had a great time, and we look forward to being there for WWF Fully Loaded, July 26th, the next In Your House event.
Man.
Full slam now, center of the ring. Leg drop. Farouk making it look easy.
Well, it's never easy, but he does make it look that way, and I've got to ask you this. How do you know this kid's from Cleveland?
Didn't you hear his ring announce?
No, I didn't.
Well, we were in commercial at the
That's
time.
Right.
You better pay attention. Quit ordering hot dogs. And what's with that shirt? Is that for the 4th of July or what?
I mean, matter of fact, this is what I wear every day. You need to shop where I... Well, no, they wouldn't let you shop where I shop.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, man.
Spine buster. Just swinging Marconi around. What do you make of the situation with The Undertaker? I mean, certainly not heeding the warning of Mr. McMahon is not a surprise, but twice now. In a span of 24 hours, he got in Stone Cold Steve Austin's face. Wait a second. Nonchalant lateral press, and Farouk removes the shoe at 2. But certainly, I mean, The Undertaker has a lot of explaining to do, wouldn't you think?
Well, I think The Undertaker is a very dangerous man to be around right now. I saw the look in his eyes when he came back to the locker room after his Hell in a Cell match with Mankind.
Oh!
He doesn't care. He threw it,
Mankind off the cage, off the top of the cage.
Some would describe The Undertaker's actions in that contest as near criminal.
Well, it's not near criminal because it was in the confines of a match. They signed a contract. It doesn't matter.
I know, but, I mean, come on. Did he go too far? I have to ask these questions because they're inside of me. I mean, I feel that way.
Did Mankind go too far? Mankind's insane. Mankind is a maniac, but I think Undertaker might have crossed the line. He doesn't care. Does he care about his brother Kane? He showed that he didn't care. He doesn't care about Mr. McMahon. He doesn't care about Stone Cold. He doesn't care about anybody.
Well, yeah, there were no innocent parties in that Hell in a Cell match.
Oh, wait a second.
What's this?
Inside cradle. Marconi gets the two before Farouk kicks out and then drills him with a clothesline.
Certainly no innocent parties by far in what has to be the most talked about matchup in WWF history. Hell in a Cell. If I never see that cell again, it will be too soon. I mean, that is going to spawn nightmares in a generation. I'm telling you.
Well, I hope it does spawn nightmares in a generation. It might wake them up. Might wake up a lot of the superstars here in the WWF. Know who to cross and who not to cross. And you especially.
And now it looks to be Dominator time.
Oh, man! Looked like his neck stepped forward a little bit on that.
And once again, another nonchalant cover, but this one effective. A day at the park for Farouk.
Wow. And he is looking bigger and nastier every day.
A lot of new superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. Val Venus, Edge. What about Steve Regal? Could be gunning for Farouk.
Interesting.
Right. Let's take a trip to Slam Jam. Say hi to Doc Hendricks.
Hey, everybody. Yo, what's up? How are you feeling? Myself, I feel good. I feel real good because for weeks and weeks, I told you that I thought that the King of the Ring that just took place this past Sunday, June 28th, had the chance of being the best King of the Ring of all time. And man, did I hit that nail on the head. It was the greatest King of the Ring of all time from the WWF Championship match with the First Blood stipulations, Stone Cold losing the title. He did not get pinned, and the man that busted Stone Cold open was not his opponent. But what about the new 1998 King of the Ring Award winner, Ken Shamrock? I tell you, the final matchup with Shamrock and The Rock, the Intercontinental Champion, the greatest finals ever in the King of the Ring tournament. Now, after that match was over, our cameras caught up with The Rock, and he wasn't taking defeat lying down.
Oh, you guys finally can't get enough of the people's champ, can you? Well, let The Rock just say something, make yourself useful, keep the camera on. What you saw out there tonight, King of the Ring, was a bunch of bullshit to begin with. Yeah, Ken Shamrock, you run your mouth, and hey, The Rock's been known to run his mouth too once in a while. You beat The Rock right in the middle of the ring, 1, 2, 3. But let me tell you something, Ken Shamrock, there ain't nobody, and The Rock means nobody, that could ever put The Rock out for good. You can do whatever you want to. What's next for The Rock? Well, hell, it ain't the King of the Ring. The King of the Ring really doesn't matter to The Rock. The fact of the matter is this, is that The Rock still has 16 pounds of gold, 6 diamonds custom made for The Rock's hardcore impeccable body. And the fact of the matter is this, whether it's Stone Cold Steve Austin, Ken Shamrock, Undertaker, the list goes on. The Rock will do what he does best, and that's lay the smack down in a major way.
Well, The Rock may not take defeat lying down, but he does lie about defeat. He did not get pinned. He gave up in the middle of the ring. Now, when we come back on Slam Jam, we're going to take a look at that unbelievable Hell in a Cell match. And don't forget, our next pay-per-view extravaganza is Sunday, July 26th from California. Fully loaded in your house.
Still to come on Shotgun. Funk and Ronald team up to take on the new Age Outlaws.
Plus, Stone Cold regained the WWF title last Monday on Raw. How? We'll show you.
And up next, tag team action featuring Ty and Ty. Shotgun rolls on. We told you China was a factor in that match with the King of the Ring, and you saw it right there.
And don't think the nation has forgot about China either, pal.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I mean, don't think they forgot about it. That's what I mean. Do you understand English?
Sitting in for Michael Cole, who's on assignment this week, is Tom Pritchard. I'm Kevin Kelly. Thanks for joining us once again on Shotgun. Tag team action. Hoppy Chulo and Steve Casey are in the ring. And here comes Yamaguchi-san leading
Kayatai. Yamaguchi-san. At a combined weight of 426 pounds, KO and Bukaki, Kayentai!
I want to thank all our fans for making Raw Is War the most watched sports entertainment program once again this week. We couldn't do without you, great folks. And you gotta wonder what's going through Yamaguchi-san's mind after Val Venus did a little gyrating, gesturing towards Mrs. Yamaguchi.
Well, you know that the Japanese are very polite people, and they don't take too kindly to people like Val Venus over in their country, although they do like to put the little quarters in the TV sets in the hotels. I know about that. But we're in the States. I don't think it's right. I don't think it's right for us for... Yamaguchi-san to have his wife sitting ringside. If you want my honest opinion, I think women should be in the back. I don't think they need to come to wrestling matches and sit front row ringside.
Wait a minute, I suppose you're going to say they probably should be barefoot and pregnant.
No, not pregnant, but barefoot sounds good.
Oh, my. Yeah. Enough of this.
Oh.
Casey starting things off against Sho Funaki. This is going to be a very, very intense pace match. Misses with the clothesline. Casey catches him. Flying tackle. Back up on his feet quickly. KO in from behind. Caught with a hip toss. Leg sweep into a chop kick. Man.
Well, you got to wonder if Kayatai is still thinking about Taka and the headbangers.
Could be. Oh, my. Great combination move there as Casey sends both Funaki and KO out to the floor. I smell an upset.
Well, this show of Steve Casey's been very impressive. And Kayatai hasn't helped their cause either. Anyway.
And Poppy Chulo certainly. Is that coat muskrat or what?
Do you have one?
Do you have one like that?
Let me ask you, where do you get your clothes, pal? You look like you could use a little fashion statement going on.
I get
on.
Mine from Shop Zone.
Yeah, I
figure. That's where all the WWF fans shop. Where do you shop, Pimps or Us?
No, my name's not Puppy Chulo. Well, we do have a lot of common, yeah.
Well, like what?
Well, we both get a lot of women.
Okay. Funaki now in from the blind side, and a little double team effort here from Tai and Tai. But Teo took his time, not very effective. And the members of Kai and Tai are feeling the wrath so far of Casey and Poppy Chulo. And you got to wonder.
Oh, man.
Yamaguchi-san can't be liking what he's seeing. I know he didn't like seeing his wife get the eye full.
Whoa!
Now Venus, a helo through the second row.
Well, she might have liked the what she got from Val Venus. She might have gotten a little eye full that she hasn't seen before.
Look at Casey. Hurricane Rana.
A little sloppy.
Oh, but the dropkick sends him out. And now, Casey and Poppy Chulo, looks like they got a little double team cooking. Watch out! Oh,
holy smokes! What a high-flying action by Poppy Chulo. I mean, is this the first time Casey and Chulo have teamed together or what?
I think.
Not doing bad.
They certainly have caught Kai and Tai off guard. Kai and Tai did come up on the losing end of a very action-packed match against the Headbangers and Taka Michinoku. And kick things off at King of the Ring. And certainly Kai and Tai is going to look to ruin the life of Taka Michinoku. But what about what happened with Val Venus? I mean, really, that was a shocking situation. Val even almost anticipated Kai and Tai's attack and headed them off at the pass.
Well, you know, she wasn't a bad-looking lady. I got to hand it to Yamaguchi-san. He's got a nice-looking wife, but if he wants to make sure she's okay, don't ever put her on the front row during a Val Venus match.
Inverted atomic drop for the second rope, and now the tag is made. Funaki is in. Very nice maneuver from Teo. These young men from Japan are innovators. They come up with some very creative, high-impact maneuvers. They spend hours and hours in the gym perfecting not only solo efforts like that one there, but also tag team maneuvers, not just involving two members, but the third member, Dick Togo, as well. And perhaps they are the finest six-man combination in the world today.
That's what I like about these guys. They take their job seriously, and they don't just mess around. And there's an eye full for you, Kevin.
Poppy Chulo, flat on his back. Kai and Tai, the double-teaming attack. Those styrofoam heads very prominent in the crowd. I know they're reminiscent of Al Snow and Head, and I'm not so sure what Al Snow's future is in the World Wrestling Federation anymore after he and Head lost to Two Bucks.
Oh, wow!
Tag made, though. Poppy Chulo, and here comes Steve Casey, who is letting the members of Kai and Tai have it. Volteo and Funaki on the receiving end.
Got to hand it to this young Steve Casey and Poppy Chulo as well, working very well as a tag team for the first time.
Irish whip sent across. Look at this, monkey flip out of the corner.
No!
Great leg strength there from Casey. He really launched Funaki, and now a collision in the center of the ring. One more time, sending Teo across. Casey catches the spine buster, floats up,
hooks
the leg two, and he got him. No, he did not. Funaki made the save as Mike Chioda's hand was about to come down for the third time. What an upset that would have been. Now, take advantage of the situation. Can they do it? Kayatai!
Oh, man!
Off the shoulder, DDT. Hooks the leg. Legal man is Funaki. And the three count is told.
Here are your winners of the championship.
Japan number one, Kelly. How do you like that?
He's holding up three fingers, though.
Yeah.
I guess that's the three members of Kayatai. A big win for the Yamaguchi-san's troop on Shotgun. Still to come here on Shotgun. Funk and Runnels team up to take on the WWF Tag Team Champions.
What's up next? Stone Cold Steve Austin is WWF Champion once again. We have that footage. Stay with us.
I don't think the World Wrestling Federation or Mankind will ever be the same. Hopefully we'll never see again the brutality that took place inside and outside Hell in a Cell.
Well, it's amazing Mankind is walking, much less breathing.
It certainly is. I had a brief conversation with Mankind. Basically lost consciousness through the end part of that contest. Fans, if you didn't see Hell in a Cell in its completion at King of the Ring, you're going to have to wait for the home video because it's never going to be shown in WWF programming.
Going to my library.
Oh, man, I'll tell you what, the King of the Ring was a classic. And I think Vader is going to look to write a short story here this week against Frank Stiletto on Shotgun. Had a brief conversation with Vader before his contest. And he says the meter is running, and he's going to make it quick.
Well, I've watched Vader train for the last couple weeks, ever since his match with Kane. And he has really gotten into some kind of shape, and he wants to prove it to everyone here in the World Wrestling Federation, officials, as well as morons like you.
Well, Bradshaw is going to be next on Vader's hit parade this Monday on Raw. Misses with the clothesline. Stiletto runs right into a brick wall. Certainly, Bradshaw was very impressive this past week on Raw in the Brawl for All tournament. He advanced to the next round, defeating Mark Canterbury, former Henry Godwin. And oh, wow!
Big powerbomb by Vader. I don't think this kid's going to get up.
And, of course, we also saw Steve Blackman defeat Mark Merrill in a match that really proved to me that a superior wrestler can defeat a boxer. That's going to be something to think about for the rest of the Brawl for All tournament, which will have its completion at SummerSlam. And it is time. It is time. It is Vader Bomb time. Look out below. Two and three. You can drop the hammer on the meter because this one is over. Where he'll battle Bradshaw. Vader time looking great here on Shotgun.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. You know, it's no secret I've been in this business a little while. I heard that. Okay, I've been in the business a long time. Nevertheless, to date, I had never seen a pay-per-view event like the King of the Ring, and I surely had never seen a match like Hell in a Cell. From the unbelievable beginning, Mankind and The Undertaker fighting on top of the cell, The Undertaker tossing Mankind off of the top of the cell through an announce table. Then they started to carry Mankind out on a stretcher. He gets up off the stretcher, climbs back up on top of the cell, gets choked, slammed through the top of it, and eventually pinned. I've never seen anyone with that resiliency or that insanity. Nevertheless, the greatest match I had ever seen. But another great match took place, the finals of the King of the Ring tournament. Now, in the first Slam Jam, we talked to the runner-up, the current Intercontinental Champion, The Rock. Well, then our cameras caught up with the winner, the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock.
When I started this, I said I was going to climb the mountain. And when it was all over, said, and done,
I'd be standing on top of that mountain, king of the ring. Well, that has been fulfilled. And all I see in my future now is bigger and better mountains to climb. And you can count on one thing, I'm gonna climb them.
Well, we all want to definitely congratulate the WWF King of the Ring Award winner, Ken Shamrock. And I guess congratulations go out to the WWF champion once again, Stone Cold Steve Austin. But don't you wonder what's going to happen now between Stone Cold, Kane, and Kane's older brother, The Undertaker? Possibly we'll find out this Monday on Raw, or maybe at the next World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view spectacular. Fully loaded in your house. From California, Sunday, July 26th.
Up next, are you ready for tag team action? It's next on Shotgun. Skittles, Bite Size Candy, proudly presents WWF Fully Loaded in your house. Live, Sunday, July 26th from California.
Oh, you didn't know? Your ass better call somebody! Wow, I held that for a long time.
You held a lot of things for a long time, pal.
Will they hold the tag team titles for a long time? The New Age Outlaws, in many respects, revolutionized tag team wrestling.
Oh, I think they have revolutionized tag team wrestling in every respect.
Will the trend continue? Will the ring announcement continue? Howard Finkel's jealous. He wishes he had a set of pipes like Road Dogg.
He wishes he was part
of
the
music.
Look at China.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, D-Generation X proudly brings to you and accompanied to the ringside area by the ninth wonder of the world, Chiz Riz. I bring to you the WWF Tag Team Champions of the World, the Road Dogg, Jesse James, the Badass, Billy Gunn, the New Age Outlaws.
Well, we'll see if the Outlaws can keep the momentum going.
Yeah, I know good and well that everybody in this building is down with D-Generation X. But there might be some of you that aren't. And of course, we got two words for you.
What are you going to say, Kevin Kelly?
That's an obscenity in most God-fearing countries.
Literally in my book.
State of Texas, at a combined weight of 455 pounds, Terry Funk and Dustin Riddle.
Well, Terry Funk has teamed with Scorpion late, but recently, past 2 weeks, he's seen a team with Dustin Riddle. A very formidable duo involved in a trio who will last week as Texas defeated Tennessee. We'll see if this rough and ready Texas duo has what it takes to defeat the New Age Outlaws. China, will she be a factor on the outside in this non-title matchup?
Well, I think anytime China is out there, you've always got to consider her a factor. I'm from Texas. I appreciate the Texas team of Funk and Runnels, but at the same time, as I said earlier when the New Age Outlaws came down, they have revolutionized tag team in every respect.
Well, certainly Terry Funk could care less about the New Age Outlaws or... As Dustin gets his thoughts together, getting his mind right, and perhaps giving a little thanks. Seems to have been reborn as of late.
Well, I wish he's back in the womb after this.
Big forearm. That's going to be a slugfest. I don't think it's going to be very pretty at all. Fired across, Dustin takes him down with a tackle. Up and across, leapfrog from Road Dogg. Sets for the monkey flip, but well scouted by Runnels.
Oh,
clubby clothesline down across the side of the ear, and Road Dogg's equilibrium is shot. He thinks Billy Gunn is to the right when he's to the left, or vice versa. And speaking of vice versa, here comes Terry Funk, who could rearrange the rather interesting-looking features of Road Dogg Jesse James, quick, fast, in a hurry as he rings up the left arm.
Well, you've got the experience and determination in there against youth.
and just pure out meanness.
Right now, Road Dogg was about begging for Terry Funk to stop wailing on him with that elbow. Off the tag, tattoos, Billy Gunn with a straight left hand. And now out on the floor, and this is danger zone if you're Billy Gunn. You don't want to go outside with the hardcore legend. That's his playground out there, and he'll ruin your life and shorten your career. Oh, man.
Well, the New Age Outlaws are in trouble right now, and they don't want to be on the outside with Terry Funk. Billy better get in the ring and make a tag.
New Age Outlaws got a lot in their mind. Number one contenders for those belts of Kane and Mankind. Pounding away is Terry Funk. Wait a minute, Road Dogg off the apron.
Well, they better not look before Terry Funk and Dustin Runnels right now. Let's get them a loss here and really lose their momentum.
Look at this. The strength elevates Funk. He's in a bad way. Folks, this match is far from over, but our director tells us we've got to take a break. We will do so. We'll return. A shotgun. The New Age Outlaws taking on the team of Terry Funk and Dustin Runnels. This non-title contest has been far from easy for the champs. They have found Runnels and Funk a formidable duo.
Well, I don't know if this new attitude by Dustin Runnels is really helping him too much in this match right now. He seems to be a little more forgiving, if you will.
Well, he had no focus at all beforehand. Lateral press and
Runnels too much focus now.
Well, no, and certainly the attack of the Road Dogg and VA Billy Gunn will make you unfocused. Off the tag, you see how the Outlaws trap Runnels on their side of the ring, not allowing Dustin to escape the attack, and now head of steam and the knee drop right to the prefrontal lobe. Lateral press hooks the leg this time. Didn't lay all of his frame across him. Perhaps that allowed Dustin to kick out at two. Boy, Raw is War is going to be electric this week, folks. And certainly after, once again, being the number one, the highest rated sports entertainment program last Monday night, you know that everyone is going to be watching what happens when Double J takes on the new King of the Ring, Ken Shamrock.
Wow.
Vader takes on Bradshaw, plus a whole lot more this Monday on Raw.
What about Austin, The Undertaker, Mankind, Kane? Everybody's going to be on Raw this week.
The new WWF champion, the second time champ now, Stone Cold. Certainly it's going to be very interesting if we get to hear from the champ. What are his thoughts about The Undertaker? What about the man from the dark side? What's going through his mind? Dustin Runnels now with a great counterattack. Wow, what a maneuver.
And what is going to happen with Ken Shamrock, the 1998 King of the Ring? Where is this going to take his career?
Certainly, King of the Ring winners of the past have found the cape and crown to be the catapult, shall we say, to immortality. The tag is made. Speaking of an immortal, it's Terry Funk. And off the tag, he's letting the Outlaws have it. Rights and lefts. Clean in house. Billy Gunn goes down and now set for the ride across.
Oh, big backdrop by Funk.
Launched up into the lights for the hardcore legend. Funk setting for the DDT. This could be all she wrote.
Oh,
and there it is. Center of the ring.
He just needs to cover him.
And now, wait a minute. China's in.
Oh, don't showboat here, Funk.
What is that? 53-year-old man shouldn't be doing that.
China shouldn't be doing that to a 53-year-old man or any major man.
As a result of the disqualification, Dustin Runnels and Terry Funk.
Wonder if that'll change that Viagra dosage for Terry Funk. Well, anyway.
Oh, come on.
Dustin now. Dustin asking for forgiveness?
Well, he's doing the wrong thing to the wrong chick.
You call China a chick again, and I'll call her over here.
Yeah, go ahead. She's a friend of mine.
He's like laying hands on her. Oh! China just laid hands.
Attitude with you.
Well, a disqualification. New Age Outlaws are nonplussed and giving you a little something to think about there.
It sure doesn't seem to bother them any. They got the right attitude. They've got the winning attitude.
They've also got Kane and Mankind in their rearview mirror. They're the tag team champions for now, but there is going to be a title confrontation somewhere down the line. Let's take a look at what China had to do in this one.
All Funk had to do was come to the Road Dogg, but he decided to let his feelings be known about DX, and China let her feelings be known.
Michael Cole and Double K, Kevin Kelly. Where were you last week? I was on assignment. I want to see your time sheet.
I was with Sable, trying to get down to the bottom of why she's back here in the WWF.
You leave Sable's bottom out of it.
Bombastic
Bob Holly set for singles action this week, and he's going to have his hands full. And folks, what a broadcast we have for you on Shotgun. So Bob Holly will be taking on the tournament that everybody's talking about, and it certainly has taken a lot of the WWF superstars out of their natural element, puts them in a new form of combat, very exciting, very entertaining.
I'll tell you what, full contact, total combat, and it's interesting to be back in the locker room area with the rest of the superstars as they're watching the Brawl for All matches, picking sides and cheering everybody on. It really is a great innovation here in the World Wrestling Federation. Draws against Bob Holly, whips him into the ropes now. Look at this. Look at the strength of Darren Drozdoff slamming him down to the canvas. And Draws follows it up and misses with the elbow.
Took a couple of extra steps there, but Holly missed with an elbow of his own. Draws shows his quickness.
Bob again whipped off the ropes and nice takedown by Draws. Otherwise known as Puke, the former football star from the University of Maryland, of course, played for the Denver Broncos in the NFL.
Certainly lives up to his name, does Puke, and In fact, we just recently did an interview with Draws for the Raw magazine, which will be coming out in a couple of months. And kind of an interesting story about how he kind of got done over by the Broncos. He's got a little bit of a bitter attitude about his days in the NFL. Carry that over to the squared circle.
Listen to the people really behind the Draws this week. Folks, still to come on Shotgun. You're going to want to stick around. We're going to take you back to this past week in the War Zone, that triple threat match to determine the number one contender. What a finish to Raw this past week.
Well, certainly more questions now than ever before regarding the WWF champion and his title reign as Bob Holly fires Draws across.
Big boot now by Draws into the face of a bombastic Bob Holly. And there's Draws with a big old clothesline.
What lengths will The Undertaker go to? I mean, now he is the number one contender, and he seems to be obsessed with becoming the champion.
I mean, look at, he concocted that plan to actually dress up in his brother's outfit. We'll take a look at that a bit later on here in Shotgun. But Bob Holly now really trying to make a move here against Drozdoff.
I think I've got some insight on exactly what is going through The Undertaker's mind. We'll speculate on that later on.
Holly now off the rope. Blocked by Darren Drozdoff. Great height that time, but Bob Holly with the kick to the midsection.
Well, Draws got a little bit lost in there for a step. That sometimes happens with rookies. A veteran like Holly's able to capitalize. You see him using agility and strength to put Draws down. Now, Holly needs to capitalize on Draws' rookie mistakes.
Currently one half of the NWA World Tag Team Champions, Bob Holly of the Midnight Express. You know, he's also held the Intercontinental title and the WWF Tag Team title. As Drozdoff now hammers away at Holly.
And certainly when Raw is War is live this Monday from the Continental Airlines Arena, it is going to be absolutely a jacked up atmosphere. So many questions going in. What is DX going to do next? Or better yet, what's the Nation going to do to DX after that hysterical parody a week ago?
Very amusing. More on that a bit later on. You'll see that parody. As Bob Holly,
you mean we're going to show some of that?
We're going to see it.
We're going to see D'Lo and the Nation's, the
in
people's chump.
Oh,
I loved it.
Holly now, top rope, Drozdoff in trouble. If Holly connects here, it could be over. And he does. Elbow to the sternum.
I'm not sure he landed as solidly as he would have liked.
Hooks the leg. There's two. Drozdoff gets the right shoulder up.
It seemed that Holly had to change his direction in midair. And that perhaps is the saving grace here, as now Cornette has left the broadcast position. Shotgun Saturday night just to our right. And now he's getting animated.
And here's Bob Holly now as Drozdoff, the 265-pounder, battles back on Bombastic Bob. Big right hands down. Whips him into the corner with authority. Oh! Drozdoff caught the turnbuckle that time in the midsection.
Plus, in a few moments, fans, we'll show you the shotgun debut of the Beast.
Can't
Dan
wait for that one.
Severn will make his shotgun debut right after this match.
Holly setting him up now. Nice suplex that time. Drozdoff felt that one small in the back. Holly goes for a cover again, hooks the leg. There's two, and once again, a kick out by Puke.
Draws has definitely shown his toughness. The Brawl for All battle with his friend Hawk, official decision was a draw. But there's a lot of speculation on the internet. A lot of people are talking about this, that they might have to relook at that tape and go back and see once again, really review this decision.
What about Savio Vega's performance in Brawl for All?
No doubt about that at all. Savio Vega was dominant over Brockus, gave up a lot of size, but he came through.
Sleeper hold now by Bob Holly.
Oh, wait
a minute. By Drozdov. Nice move. Nice counter by the rookie.
Well, I tell you, it was refreshing to have Tom Pritchard here with me last week. I was calling play-by-play. Pritchard was analyzing. I mean, you really should go back and study that tape. You might learn a few things.
Learn a few things about what?
Announcing. Call the match.
Drozdov now hammering away. Holly whips into the ropes. Here he comes. Drozdov with a big old elbow. Holly knocked down.
Oh, man.
By a clothesline. And another one. Great reaction by these WWF fans for Puke.
People love Puke.
Here's Drozdov now once again. Sunset flip. He may have him here, but Holly kicks out.
Cardinal mistake by Droz. Did not drape the legs over the arms of Holly. And that allowed half of the Midnight Express to get out of that pinning predicament.
Oh, what a power slam. Garrett Drozdov. And Holly felt that one. But Droz once again misses with the elbow. A little too much time there on the follow-up.
Well,
a combination
of rookie mistakes can add up to a loss. But Holly hasn't been able to put them all together yet.
Top rope now. Droz got the boot up. And Holly in the face. And Droz setting him up now. This could be it. Oh! It should be it. It's over. Cute win.
What a win for Droz. Kicking his off on shotgun.
Let's take a look at what happened at the end of this matchup to give Droz the victory.
Well, certainly it was this mistake by Holly that gave the opening for this. Tiger Bomb-like maneuver and the victory for Droz.
Draws on a roll in the WWF. Hey, here's handsome Doc Hendricks. And here he comes, the beast, Dan Severin, a man who certainly has an issue with D'Lo Brown, who you saw in the Slam of the Week.
The holding contest is scheduled for one call with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring from Coldwater, Michigan, weighing 250 pounds, Dan the Beast Severin.
Oh, the look in the eye of the beast. That's not a good thing for G.I. Bro.
Tell you what, there he is, G.I. Bro, going to have his hands full with the beast, Dan Severin. You recall, back a few weeks ago, the qualifying part of the King of the Ring tournament, Severin ripped the pectoral muscles in the chest of D'Lo Brown. D'Lo now wears a chest protector, but he came back and helped knock Severin out of the King of the Ring.
Yeah, and it seems odd that a man still suffering the effects of torn pectoral muscles is able to deliver the lowdown seemingly with no pain. I want to know what this chest protector is all about, and I'm going to do some investigating.
Here's Severin now, lock up with a G.I. Bro. Now, if you're G.I. Bro, Kevin, your strategy for this matchup against the Greco-Roman specialist, the Beast.
Run. There is no defense. There is no strategy. Get out of the ring. Why sign up for a match like this?
Well, what do you do, though? You obviously don't want to be in the middle of the ring against Severin. You need to play on the ropes, stay on
your
feet. Well,
obviously, you need to try to avoid any type of submission maneuvers. And right now, G.I. Bro is making the cardinal mistake. While avoiding the pinfall predicament and floating over to his stomach, he leaves all 5 points of balance open for a submission attack from Severin.
Hey, folks, you heard Doc Hendrick talk about it at Fully Loaded. We talked about it all weekend long, the bikini contest between Sable and Jackson.
How about that?
I cannot wait.
That is going to be an eyeful. Let it all hang out, shall we say.
Who's going to win?
I don't know. The fans, basically.
I love my job. I'm going to be right down there, front row if I can.
Yeah, well, the last time Sable was in a bikini, you know, that potato sack went the way of the door, and all of a sudden, you know, ba ba boom, hello.
Hey, Jacqueline ain't gonna lose
that. Oh, man, I think the beast is upset with you. I understand you parked in his spot or something.
The beast now just beating the heck out of G.I. Bro.
Well, certainly Dan Severn is out to prove a point. I think in large part Dan Severn would have been the King of the Ring if D'Lo Brown had not interfered in the semifinal match against The Rock. Just think about it. Shamrock and Severn would have been in the finals. Who do you think would have won out of that one?
Shamrock.
Oh, you say that with such conviction. I beg to differ.
Nonetheless, Shamrock is the 1998 King of the Ring. We saw former King of the Ring Mabel this past week on Raw. Shamrock,
oh, man.
King Mabel as well. And Severn now.
Look at this.
That's a chokeout hold. That would be a legal maneuver in the Ultimate Fighting world, but of course, against the rules here, the WWF and Severn forced to break the hold.
Well, he is just manhandling G.I. Bro, the spear, the chokeout, and now the weight block, German suplex. What a maneuver.
And Severn now, look out, setting up G.I. Bro now for the submission hold. The same move here, which breaks the pectoral muscle in D'Lo Brown's chest. WWF. Folks, still to come on Shotgun. Farouk and Scorpio take on Too Hot and Too Sexy. That's the tag team of Too Much. Plus, Triple H with DX mocked the nation last Sunday. We'll show you that hysterical parody. And up next, a Live Wire exclusive. Edge takes on Jesus. Stay with us.
Well, it's a hot one out there. It's going to be a scorcher. You're going to be in feet. Don't forget the sunset.
Something wrong, Flex?
I need to make a call for the lift change on the flying kit.
I see, and your precious little tootsies can't bear the walk back, can they?
No.
Not to worry. Just dial 1-800-COLLECT. It's fast and really easy to use.
1-800-COLLECT's a lifesaver. How can I ever thank you?
Tell your friends.
1-800-COLLECT. It's fast, it's easy, it's safe.
This is for my grandfather, who always said I'd make the family proud. For my mom, who never let me out the door without my homework. For my dad, who worked the night shift to make our lives better.
Play for you, buddy.
For myself, for my future.
Be all that you can be.
Table dates back to the late 1800s. Now, 100 years later, it's called an heirloom. Today at Oak Express, you'll also find solid oak dining tables built to last a lifetime and beyond. The solid oak Scottsdale is just $279. The solid oak Supreme table is $526. Or the solid oak Stafford is $649. And ask about our free financing programs. Oak, the heirloom wood at Oak Express. In Appleton on West College Avenue and in Green Bay.
Cholesterol.
Where'd you hear about cholesterol?
School. And they said a lot isn't good for your heart.
That's right.
Is that why we're watching what we eat now?
Yeah. On Cheerios.
An important new study shows that 3 cups of Cheerios, whole grain oats a day, added to a low-fat diet, can help push your cholesterol down.
We're fighting cholesterol right now.
Well, then have more, Dad.
This week's Shotgun is brought to you by WWF The Music Volume 2. Experience your favorite WWF original jam, now available in stores. And by Skittles, bite-sized candy. 3 weeks ago, Edge almost ended the career of Jose of Los Frenicos. Right now, a Live Wire exclusive matchup. Jesus of Los Frenicos tries for revenge against Edge.
And his opponent, from Toronto, Canada, weighing in at 240 pounds,
ready for one-on-one competition featuring Edge versus Jesus of Los Periquas. Jim Ross and Kevin Kelly here at ringside. And Kevin, Edge has got a lot of people talking, and Edge not wasting any time taking down Jesus of Los Periquas.
A lot of talking being done by Jesus earlier this afternoon. Said he's looking for revenge for the injury put upon Jose just about 3 weeks ago, courtesy of Edge.
Edge put Jose out of action with that neck injury. And Jose's going to be out of action about 8 weeks, we understand. And now Edge, the young man from Toronto, is a very...
Oh,
complex individual, from what we understand, Kevin. Very bright future, but certainly a very dark dark soul. And a conversation with Edge is very short and very to the point, and but yet still somewhat mysterious.
Young man is in his early 20s. Went through the WWF training camp, and certainly we talked to Dory Funk Jr. about the abilities of Edge, and Dory Jr. very, very high on this young man's athletic ability. And hard knock that chop by the veteran Jesus Castillo. And again, Jesus with a huge experience advantage here. Wow. And nowhere to go for Edge but down.
And certainly Jesus is going to look to exploit some of the potential for young mistakes from Edge. And with the measure of revenge that Jesus brings to the ring, this could be a very, very long outcome here for Edge.
And when you talk about revenge, you got to wonder what kind of revenge Mr. McMahon, Vince McMahon, the owner of the WWF, is going to take this Monday on Raw, because Stone Cold Steve Austin is the WWF champion again, and we all know that Mr. McMahon does not like it as we take another look at some of this offense.
But as you said, JR, nowhere to go. Edge in the corner, the drop kick to the chest, and Jesus then follows up on the offense. He's been effective outside and inside the ring.
I'll tell you what, Kevin, after what happened last Monday on Raw, you got to believe that this Monday sellout crowd in the Continental Airlines Arena are going to be turned on, because no doubt that Mr. McMahon, The Undertaker, Mankind, Kane, and who knows who else is going to join the long growing list of adversaries for the Rattlesnake. And there's a cover and a near fall situation.
I'm sure the Rattlesnake did not expect his second reign as WWF champion to go easy, but to me, JR, it seems like it's going to be more and more difficult for him to hang on to this title.
I'll tell you one thing, it's going to be... Come on. Oh, look at this. Edge fighting right back up. Jesus unloading on Edge. And Edge, the young man that's in his early 20s, he's single. He's from Toronto, and he is here and ready to fight. And the competitive spirit, the edge that this young man possesses, no pun intended, is absolutely off the page here, and a high elevation. Tremendous back body drop there.
Well, if he can keep that energy focused, he can be very deadly and very dangerous. Jose found that out a couple of weeks ago. Will Jesus be next?
Deadly and dangerous. That's the tag team scene when The Undertaker and Stone Cold will be forced to be tag team partners, reluctant as they may be, against Mankind and Kane at Fully Loaded. And the elbow, the reverse elbow, followed by a lateral press, got another near fall for Edge. Well, I'll tell you what, Fully Loaded, nothing has been more aptly named, and you got to wonder if Austin is stepping into some sort of trap at Fully Loaded. Oh, boy, what a kick.
Well, that should be it. If Jesus is able to make the cover, this will be the three right here.
Jesus may have busted the lip there, the mouth of Edge on that heel kick. And another hard knife-edge chop, and again the veteran, Jesus Castillo of Los Periquas, keeping Edge off balance here a little bit. And now Edge, the quicker of the two, oh my!
Called the downward spiral by Edge.
And that'll be all she wrote for Jesus as Edge continues his winning ways here. The mysterious youngster from Toronto with another victory. And he's got a busted lip, but I don't think he cares.
His work's not done yet. And a non-traditional entrance and exit for a non-traditional athlete, but a top-notch star on the rise.
There is no doubt about it that if Edge can stay healthy, that this young man from Toronto is going to be one of the biggest superstars in the WWF in the years to come. Edge remains undefeated.
Still to come on Shotgun. Tag team action as Faruka Scorpio take on the tag team of Too Much. Plus, we'll relive DX's parody on The Nation.
And if anybody smells what The Rock is cooking, it's me. Look how big my damn nose is.
And up next, the outcome of the triple threat to see who would be the number one contender for the title.
It's 1998. One teacher is living in fear.
My brother killed my sister.
How did he do that?
With a really big kitchen knife.
Now, The face of good and the face of evil will meet one last time. But this time, it's going to be a fight to the finish. Halloween H2O. Rated R. Wednesday, August 5th at a theater near you.
Traveling with any baggage?
Yeah, here he comes now. Hey, what are you looking at?
Hey, no peanut jokes.
I feel so violated. What is so suspicious about candy-coated chocolates who walk and talk? I guess you gotta check out everybody, though.
Wow.
Great casting job. Excuse me, gorgeous. Is this a snack flight?
It is now. Do you ever wish you could do this? Or even this? An entertainment center from Oak Express makes it easy. Prefer a traditional look? No problem. Come to Oak Express. Oak Express has entertainment centers in every style and price range. Something to make your every wish come true. Well, Oak Express.
In Appleton on West College Avenue at the South Mall entrance and in Green Bay.
You already know how important calcium is for your bones, but did you know that 85% of women still don't get enough? So start your day with Total. It's the only leading cereal that's an excellent source of calcium, even before adding milk. In fact, Total has more calcium than the milk itself. No other leading cereal comes close. Simple, low-fat, delicious. So good, you can feel it in your bones. Total. Total Raisin Bran, Total Corn Flakes. One bowl, one great source of calcium.
Tell you what, the world was shocked after what we saw this past Monday night. We'll talk more about that in just a moment.
With a 20-minute time limit, it's Lucy Burke from Endell, Pennsylvania, weighing 245 pounds, the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman.
Steve Blackman, extremely impressive here in the World Wrestling Federation. He gets set to take on Lance Diamond. But what about his performance at Brawl for All? Talk about a thrashing. Blackman absolutely pummeled Marvelous Mark Merrow. It was a mix of takedowns and boxing skill. Blackman surprised a lot of people with his dominating performance over the Marvelous one, but as we heard this past week on Raw, Jacqueline seemed to take some of the blame, saying that she kept Mark up all night through 12 rounds of competition herself.
Tell you what, though, Blackman was impressive. Can't take anything away from the lethal weapon.
Absolutely not. He's so quick. I think that's what makes him so devastating in this brawl for all. He is so quick.
Yeah, that's it, Lance Diamond. Let's egg on the martial arts expert. Go ahead. Good idea.
Blackman in action, but to get back to what we saw this past week, The Undertaker is obviously obsessed with winning the WWF Championship from Stone Cold Steve Austin. I mean, he concocted this plan, went so far as to wear his brother's outfit into the ring. I mean, this guy is obsessed.
Well, we certainly know now that The Undertaker is in the driver's seat. He's in the best position possible. He's the number one contender. How did The Undertaker get into Kane's gear? Great agility there for Blackman. What I spoke about earlier, I got some things about this I want to bring to light right now. I don't think that The Undertaker and Kane are in cahoots. What, I don't think that Kane and The Undertaker are working together on this at all. There's an outside force. And I think that force is going to come to light. There's a third party that's involved in this.
Paul Bearer?
Someone else that wants a WWF title off of Stone Cold Steve Austin. Set all this plan in motion. I got a feeling we're going to find out more about it live this Monday on Raw.
What a takedown by Blackman. Well, who could it be? Paul Bearer? What about Mr. McMahon?
What about Mankind?
That's interesting.
There's a lot of factors here. You can't just look at The Undertaker. You can't just look at Kane. There are other people involved in this. I think it's an outside source.
I just can't get over how obsessed The Undertaker is right now with getting the title from Stone Cold Steve Austin, at least on paper.
Well, and look at everything that The Undertaker has done over the past few months, from vicious attacks, things on innocent victims we've never seen him done before. How about this past Monday, where he chokeslammed Terry Funk, the hardcore legend loved by everybody? I mean, Taker has snapped. He's gone way, way over the edge.
Blackman now backing Diamond into the ropes. Here comes Lance Diamond. Blackman telegraphing it, caught the boot to the face. There's the drop kick. Blackman still on his feet. And now he swats away Diamond like a fly.
Boy, Blackman is so impressive with his agility, but also his strength. And you look at a man built like him,
just at that 240-pound mark, but he's so lean and so compact. He's got a lot of strength in those muscles.
You're talking about Mankind and Kane before. You know, Mankind and Kane could leave the Continental Airlines Arena this Monday night when Raw is war with the tag team titles.
Certainly could. They'll face the New Age Outlaws live this Monday, and there ain't going to be no ha-ha. There won't be any parody. Boston Crab, single leg crab here. This could do it.
No ha-ha here for Lance Diamond. This submission hold, and Diamond wisely gets to the ropes.
And what do you think the nation is going to do to DX?
Oh, man.
I mean, you know that the emotions are just going to boil over this Monday live on Raw.
And coming up next, we'll show you the parody the nation, oh, I should say DX pulled on the nation. It was highly amusing. At least for us here.
Yeah, for everybody except the nation.
Blackman now whips into the ropes by Lance Diamond. And Diamond with a nice clothesline. He's starting to make a move now in the martial arts expert.
Yeah, Diamond needs to make a cover instead of a celebration.
He's got an arm like yours.
Yeah, now you don't see me flashing it either.
And there's Diamond with a big right hand.
Speaking of, what about that chicken bone you got sticking out of your shirt? Oh, that's your arm.
Well, here we go now. Blackman up over the top. Look at this. Oh, face first. Diamond quickly back to his feet. Don't know if that was a wise move. Taken down with a chop up underneath the chin.
Well, he bounced up almost instinctively, but you could tell he was still out of it, and Blackman put him right back down.
And here's Blackman again, whips him into the ropes. Here we go now. Big kick. Big kick to the face. And Blackman says that's it. Great reaction of Blackman from these fans here. Here's Diamond once again. Another big kick.
That should do it.
Hooks the leg. It's over. Impressive victory for the Lethal Weapon.
Big win for the Lethal Weapon. But, Michael, you're telling me we're going to be able to see that DX parody again?
Yeah, coming up next. Oh. Folks, speaking of parody, here's Doc. Scorpio and Farouk making their way to the ring for tag team action. You just saw a recap of what happened in Hell in a Cell. It's King of the Ring, Undertaker, and Mankind. Once again, they will be on opposite sides and fully loaded in just 2 weeks.
Yeah, talk about tag team action. The main event of Fully Loaded is just that. Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Undertaker forced to be a team, courtesy of Mr. McMahon, to take on Mankind and Kane. And Mankind and Kane could be walking in the tag team champions. They could strut in with the gold if they defeat the Outlaws live this Monday on Raw.
Also this Monday on Raw, we could learn more matches for Fully Loaded in Your House. You're going to want to tune in. And Kevin, I'll tell you what, I may not sleep much the next 2 weeks thinking about what Sable might be wearing at that bikini contest.
Don't get yourself all in a lather yet.
What about Jackal?
Oh, man. I'll tell you what, both of them definitely are going to know how to fill a swimsuit. Do I get to be a judge?
I thought you were going to say, do you get to be in the contest?
Please.
What a scary sight that would be.
As too much now, gets set to take on Farouk and Scorpio. It'll be Scott Taylor against Farouk.
Kidding me? A chiseled physique like mine?
Oh, brother.
Chiseled out of butter, I guess you're about to say. Please just call the match.
Taylor giving away about 50 pounds here to Farouk. Showing off his physique for everybody. And Mr. Farouk does not look too impressed. Might have to teach Mr. Taylor a lesson in this one. This tag team is too much, extremely impressive. First time, though, Farouk and Scorpio have teamed up.
Actually, the last time we saw too much in action was at King of the Ring, defeating Al Snow and Head. No sighting of Al, nor the Head. A couple of biceps there that are definitely impressive.
Farouk, what a right hand. Wow. Tell you what, I'm looking forward to see how well Farouk and Scorpio team together here.
Well, they're no strangers. They know each other quite well.
And here we go now. Taylor. Nice athletic move, and Taylor's strutting now. He's going to pay for this. Look at Farouk. What is Taylor's problem?
I wonder what Farouk thought of the parody of the nation. Certainly, I'm sure the former leader of the nation enjoyed a good laugh, but as we said, not everyone was chuckling along with DX this past week on Raw. Matter of fact, certainly members of the nation themselves have something to say about that.
Brian Christian is going to cost his partner a whipping here. He's got the referee distracted, and Farouk putting it in to Scott Taylor. And look at this now. It's Scorpio keeping the referee away, and Farouk now making Christopher and Taylor pay for it.
Oh, too much leather.
See him.
Scott Taylor is crying. There is no crying in the World Wrestling Federation.
Speaking of crying, I understand that the nation, especially The Rock, may be crying after that Triple H parody this past week.
Well, from what we understand, good old JR had a conversation with The Rock, and he definitely was upset. You can find out all the details of that on Option 3, The Ross Report. That's on the WWF Superstar line. The number to call, 1-900-737-4WWF, $1.69 per minute. Kids under 18, as always, get your parents' permission before calling.
Scorpio with a big knockdown now of Brian Christopher.
Hey, Scorpio looks great.
He does. He really does. The 235-pounder hammering away now at Too Sexy. Both these guys high flyers. There's Christopher up over the top. Scoops him up, slams him down.
Yeah, but I don't think anybody can match Scorpio with his high-flying skills.
And Brian Christopher loved it.
Too much is going to have to isolate either Farouk or Scorpio. Take advantage of the double team, a lot of quick tags. Both members of Too Much make a pretty impressive physical. Well, just because there's a little public display of affection there, you have a problem with it every time.
Me? You're the one that just turned your nose up.
Well, you're the one who's always criticizing Too Much.
Well, of course, Christopher, the alleged son of Jerry the King Lawler, and Scott Taylor, might as well call him the alleged nephew of the king.
Interesting editorial from the crowd.
Yes, it is. Big knockdown by Scorpio with the shoulder. Look at this, cartwheel. There's a drop kick by Christopher. Maybe too much showboating that time by Scorpio. And Christopher now in control after the hip toss. Follows it up with a clothesline. And Brian Christopher loved it. Folks, we got to take a break.
What?
Shotgun. We'll be right back.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dan Dierdorf. Where would you go for a home equity loan? Let's ask.
Oh, banks have the best rates.
But banks only lend money when you don't need it.
Advana National Bank is different. They lend money to people when they need it.
Right. With my credit?
They made their first loans 45 years ago to teachers who had trouble borrowing. They helped out when others wouldn't.
This is a bank, right?
With customers who get the flexibility only a national bank can offer, right over the phone.
Got to move all your accounts there.
Nope, just call Advana. One of their loan specialists will show you how to use the equity in your home to pay off all of your bills. Get one low monthly payment and save hundreds of dollars a month, plus a tax deduction.
You'll wait for some board to approve.
You'll get fast approval over the phone. And your money in about 10 days. You don't need to have money in the bank to get money from a bank. To get the loan you want, call Advanta at 1-800-864-1751. You'll see, they're different. Hey, they don't keep banker's hours either.
This antique table dates back to the late 1800s. Now, 100 years later, it's called an heirloom. Today at Oak Express, you'll also find solid oak dining tables built to last a lifetime and beyond. The solid oak Scottsdale is just $279. The solid oak Supreme table is $526. Or the solid oak Stafford is $649. And ask about our free financing programs. Oak, the heirloom wood at Oak Express. In Appleton on West College Avenue and in Green Bay.
Butch Harmon is the hottest instructor in golf today. He coaches Greg Norman and Tiger Woods. And now you can benefit from his winning techniques, guaranteed to shave strokes off your score. Fox 11 and your Valley area Buick dealers will bring you a series of Butch's easy-to-understand golf tips. Learn more about the proper grip, swing, club selection, and much more. Watch for these tips broadcast during Fox 11 news and sports programs. Helping to make your golf game better is what we mean when we say Fox 11 is your home team.
We're back on Shotgun. Oh, man! What a kick by Scorpio. Rearranging the dental features of Jerry's little boy. Tell you what, his alleged son, Jerry the King Lawler's alleged son, is in La La Land.
Oh, my God!
Got something in common with Mankind. Was that a tooth in Mankind's nose?
Yeah, after that Hell in a Cell match, unreal. Oh, and here's Taylor now, trying his fare at Scorpio. Catches him with a boot to the midsection, and he calls this the too-hot drop if he connects here. Nice move by Scott Taylor into the kip-up that time. And here we go. Here's the moonwalk.
Yeah, well, apologies to Doc Hendricks.
What is Christopher? Why is he always touching it?
Why do you have a problem with celebration? Football players don't pat each other on the butt when they make a great play?
Just call the double feature.
Look at that. Strong sidekick right there. That took Brian Christopher down. You've got some real issues, Michael Cole.
Issues? I got an issue with you.
And here's you get anywhere near my issues, pal, we'll have a fight.
Look at this, double leapfrog by Too Much. Scorpio now going to pay for it here. Double team, nice move by Too Much.
Not following up, though, with a lateral press, a pin attempt, nothing. Just a little talking and gyrating.
Yeah, too much prancing around. Or too much. Nice trunks, by the way. Christopher now lifting up Scorpio, slams him down in the middle of the ring.
Well, you just have a comment on everything. Why don't you comment on Raw live this Monday for the Continental Airlines Arena?
Can you believe we sold out the Continental Airlines Arena?
That guy, we'll sell out anywhere.
We are selling out everywhere these days. So, folks, if you want to see us live, you better get your tickets as soon as they go on sale. What a drop kick by Christopher.
What an electric atmosphere it's going to be this Monday. Wait a minute, cover attempt here.
Here's Christopher now, lateral press. There's two in a... just getting the shoulder up by Scorpio.
Wow, Scorpio's really out of it thanks to this. Kick right in the back of the head. Scorpio's equilibrium is shot, and too much has done what they needed to do. They have isolated one member of this team.
Oh, look out! Collision in the center of the ring. Not the result too much was looking for. And now Scorpio trying to make a tag to Farouk. Really needs to make a tag here. The fans behind Scorpio and Farouk.
And the former All-American for Florida State. If he gets in, he's going to clean house.
Big right hand. There's another one. Too much in a lot of trouble.
It's too much Farouk right now.
Oh, my. It's an atomic drop. And Farouk's setting him up now.
Dominator.
Going for the Dominator.
Wait a
minute. Counter. Made Farouk pay for it with a kick to the midsection. Scott Taylor now. Top rope. Oh, my. Farouk hooks the leg. Taylor. In trouble as Christopher hits him with the elbow. And here comes Scorpio. Uh-oh, if he connects here, this will be over. Scorpio, top rope. 450 splash. He caught it. Hooks the leg. That's it. That's it. Farouk and Scorpio win.
Wow. What a way to wrap up Shotgun as we head to Raw Live this Monday for the Commodore. Too much had things in control. The great strength counter. The bad play decision by Too Much led to this. 450 splash and the win.
Folks, don't forget, Raw live this Monday night.
Situation involving Triple H and The Rock and their date set for Fully Loaded. I think things, there is change blowing in the wind, as they say.
And big news about Ken Shamrock and Owen Hart, where they're going to get it on at Fully Loaded, and it won't be in California.
What?
We'll tell you more about that as the show continues.
Wait a minute. I'm the one that's supposed to have the scoops here.
Well, this is going to be a big one if you haven't heard about it yet. Owen Hart and Ken Shamrock will meet, but it will not be in California.
Here we go now. Scorpio whips Jesus into the ropes. Big knockdown by Jesus Castillo of Los Barriquas.
Certainly, the members of the Barriquas are going to look to try to isolate Scorpio and avoid the power of Farouk. Scorpio and Farouk made their World Wrestling Federation tag team debut last week, very successful against Too Much. And although they are no strangers as being a tag team.
I'll tell you what, Scorpio and Farouk, long history together. In fact, Farouk played an integral part in getting Scorpio started in the sports entertainment business.
Well, certainly did, and they've got a lot of natural chemistry together, and very exciting team. Talk about excitement. What about when Shawn Michaels made his way through the curtain?
Oh, wow.
I mean, it was an explosion in the Continental Airlines Arena this past Monday.
Leapfrog by Scorpio. Here's Jesus now up over the top. Scorpio again with a big drop kick up underneath the chin. Follows it up with an arm drag into the arm bar. I'll tell you what, Heartbreak Kid is back joining the commentary team for Raw. He had some mighty interesting things to say.
Well, he certainly did, and I'm a little bit upset. Remember the call for auditions I put out a few weeks ago to replace you? Well, I had the Heartbreak Kid all set to go here on Shotgun, and all of a sudden the bigwigs, the muckety-mucks that deal with Raw, they snatched the Heartbreak Kid away from me.
Well, I mean, he's on Raw now with the King and Jim Ross. Here we go. There's the cover two and a kick out.
Well, I'm sure the Heartbreak Kid's going to be teaching those two old-timers a few new tricks.
But, folks, for now, we got to stick with Kevin Kelly here on Shotgun as we go Savio Vega with a big shot to the ribcage of Scorpio. Scorpio and Farouk will be involved in Fully Loaded. They take on Terry Funk and Bradshaw live exclusively on pay-per-view next Sunday night, July 26, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific.
Yeah, and all those four men are going to be interested because we've got new tag team champions, Kane and Mankind. We'll talk more about that in the hour. Plus, the main event has definitely changed at Fully Loaded. We'll talk about that as well.
Scorpio now, big crossbody that time. There's two and a kick out by Savio. Wow, what a kick upside the head of Savio Vega.
Well, right along the temple region, and now the tag is made. The powerhouse is in.
And here comes Farouk now. Big right hand to Savio. Folks, still to come on Shotgun. We will see the Shotgun debut of Edge. That's going to be interesting. Wow, what power by Farouk. Hooks the leg. Two and a kick out.
Yeah, that is going to be a lot of people are talking about Edge. Very little is known about this young, mysterious man from Toronto, Canada. And I've been trying, working all of my sources to try to get some background on Edge, and I've come up empty.
And it's real hard to talk to the man as well. He doesn't hang out in the locker room area. It's usually around the building, dark places. What an elbow by Farouk. And look at this, big shoulder.
Coming firing out of the corner.
And also a treat for the ladies on Shotgun this week.
Why, what?
Val Venus is
here. I thought you were going to say you were going to leave.
Oh, Val Venus is here, folks.
Certainly not on Yamaguchi-san's Christmas card list.
And here's Scorpio. Big shot now to Savio.
Although Mrs. Yamaguchi-san been talking some smack about, well, never mind.
Yeah, she met Santa Claus all right.
What?
And there's Savio now with a big move, and Scorpio feeling it. Los Periquas, tough hombres.
So we're supposed to believe she was looking for that remote control, huh?
Yeah, that's what Val wants.
Enough of that.
Jesus now off the tag, into the ring, and Scorpio's in trouble. And now the referee distracted. And Los Barriquas double team on Scorpio.
A lot of physical action. Kicking off Shotgun this week. We're going to go back, revisit Raw is War. And we're also going to talk more about this situation involving Kane and The Undertaker.
Oh,
are they in cahoots? We still don't have an answer.
Here's a cover now by Jesus, and Scorpio gets that right shoulder up. Yeah, are they in cahoots? That's going to be interesting.
Certainly, I know Raw is War this Monday. A lot of signs are pointing towards an answer before Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Undertaker step in to Fully Loaded against Mankind and Kane. Will Austin get the answers that he looks for in a match where now the tag team titles will be on the line?
Yeah, do you realize going into that, Austin could walk out of Fully Loaded with the WWF tag team titles and the WWF championship?
Or if The Undertaker is indeed with Kane, he might not be walking out.
And Scorpio catching Savio with a boot to the face, and now he tries to gain some momentum here.
Well, he's trying to gain his equilibrium, trying to figure out where he is, locate Farouk. He's got to make a tag.
Underneath the Savio now, and here comes Farouk. Farouk with a big right hand. And Savio's in trouble. Here's the reversal. Farouk off the ropes. Telegraph face first.
Oh, man.
And Jesus down. Look at this. What strength by Farouk. And here comes Scorpio now. Jesus. Middle of the ring, doesn't know where he is.
Whoa.
Wow.
What
from
distance?
The top rope. Here's the cover. Two, and Savio makes the save.
And all four men in once again. Referee Earl Hebner trying to regain control.
And Farouk hammering away now. Look out. Here we go. Mariqua sandwich. There goes Savio.
Get that with a side of plantains and some flan. It's a nice meal.
And there goes Scorpio. And Jesus with a spinning heel kick. Up underneath the chin. Farouk in trouble.
He doesn't go for the cover, though, and I'm very surprised.
Jesus taking some time here. Scoop slam of Farouk. Here's the cover now. Two, and Farouk kicks out with authority. And Jesus now going to climb the ropes.
Taking a page out of Scorpio's book.
Look out now. Farouk to his feet. Here's Jesus. Oh, wow. What strength by Farouk. The referee distracted. No tag made there.
Well, that's because I think Scorpio's the legal man.
And Scorpio now for the top rope. Oh. 450 splash. Hooks the leg. It's over. Scorpio and Farouk victorious. Folks, time now for Slam Jam. Here's Handsome Doc.
1 week away. That's right, everybody. We are 1 week away from the next World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view spectacular, and it will be the bomb, fully loaded in your house next Sunday, July 26th, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view. And let me ask you something. What's going to happen in the main event now? Stone Cold Steve Austin, the WWF champion, teams up with the number one contender, The Undertaker, and that tag team is shaky at best. They take on the deranged Mankind and Kane, who are now the WWF Tag Team Champions by virtue of their victory this past week on Raw, and we'll show you that in just a little bit. But this match now is for the Tag Team titles, and recently our cameras caught up with the new champs.
In your house, fully loaded, our Tag Team Championships are on the line against Stone Cold Steve Austin and Undertaker. It's no secret that my men have beat Undertaker before. It's no secret that my men have beat Stone Cold Steve Austin before. And it's not going to be a secret that we're going to beat you again.
That was a very vague statement by Paul Bearer. I got a feeling he knows something that we don't. That maybe Kane and Mankind will retain the WWF Tag Team titles next Sunday at Fully Loaded. With the help of The Undertaker. We will find out next Sunday. And speaking of Fully Loaded, the bikini contest between Sable and Jacqueline. And what about what Sable said this past week on Raw? That the bikini she wore at the 1997 Slammies will look like evening wear compared to what she's going to wear next Sunday. That bikini at the Slammies, there was nothing to it. It's great. You know the cliche, what goes up must go down. Maybe what goes on must come off. And don't forget, The Nation and DX will be in big form as Triple H and The Rock battle it out. Two out of three falls, title versus title. All this and so much more next Sunday at Fully Loaded on pay-per-view.
Coming up on Shotgun, Double J is in action against Dustin Runnels.
Plus, we'll have highlights of two tag team championship matches from Raw last Monday.
But up next, the tormented soul from Toronto, Edge, is in action.
Not talking, and I can't find any resources. Can't find anybody who knows the story of Edge.
Edge giving away a considerable size and weight advantage here to Pierre. But there's the quickness of the 260-pounder Edge. And the boots down to the midsection.
I wonder if Pierre, the fellow Canadian, knows anything about Edge.
And here's Pierre now, whipping Edge into the ropes. Picks him up, spin around. Nice move by Edge. And Pierre now little breather outside the ring.
Well, I would gauge by that move that Edge has spent some time in Mexico, or at least studying some of the moves of the luchadors. Very impressive head scissor there.
Look out now.
Here's Edge.
Oh, my. The same move that injured Jose of Los Pericos a few weeks ago. And we got to take a look at this again. What finesse, what athleticism by Edge.
Certainly a dangerous maneuver, as you said. And Pierre almost went the same way as Jose. Down across the shoulders and neck.
And here's Edge now, forearms to the face of Pierre, and now a rake of the eyes. Folks, don't forget, Fully Loaded in Your House, next Sunday live, exclusively on pay-per-view. I'll be in California, you'll be there too. I want a front row seat for the bikinis.
I mean, is it gonna be postage stamps and yarn thrown together for a bikini? I don't know.
Here's a cover by Edge and a kick out by Pierre.
But certainly Sable's words are still ringing in my mind. What she wore at the Slammies last time, it's going to look like an evening gown compared to what she's planning for Fully Loaded.
Who do you give the edge to?
Well, maybe Jacqueline's thinking twice after her venture on the top rope this past
week. That's right. And look at this. What a move by Pierre. You got to give the 300-pounder credit.
Just back off a knee injury. Pierre is not going to allow Edge to make a reputation on him, it appears.
And Edge now back to his feet. And Pierre going to work outside the ring. Talking about Fully Loaded. Announced this past week on Raw. Rock and Triple H title for title, but what about the new stipulation?
Now, two out of three falls. And what a test of endurance. And there is going to be one man who will have to defeat the other two times to walk away with both championship belts.
I'll tell you what, The Rock and Triple H may not be any other superstars in the World Wrestling Federation in better shape cardiovascularly, and they're going to need it.
Well, they're not going to be able to wear each other down. Certainly, it becomes the situation with outside forces. Will they come into play? The feud between DX and The Nation heated up. Certainly, Jason Sensation felt the wrath of that. We're going to show you that tragic and that sickening, nearly criminal act by Owen Hart. We'll show you that at the completion of this matchup.
It's also DX versus The Nation when X-Pac takes on D'Lo at Fully Loaded.
Oh, yeah, brother D'Lo. You know, he's looking for revenge as well, but that match is going to go 100 miles an hour.
Wow, what a power bomb.
Well, Pierre is exerting the weight advantage, exerting the experience advantage as well.
Fans don't like it. But Pierre went after the Quebecers. You know, Pierre's held the WWF Tag Team titles three separate occasions.
Yeah, you keep telling us that.
And there's a big booting out of the head. Tremendous athlete, though, for his size.
Well, he certainly is. A lot of people say, though, that if he was around that 260-pound range, he would be even better. But he uses his size to his advantage, especially in a matchup like this.
And he'll be tested this week on Raw, Brawl for All, against Dr. Death.
Oh, man. I mean, if I'm Pierre.
Here's a cover now and a kick out by Edge.
As soon as I'm done with this match, I'm going back to Quebec. I'm pulling the covers over my head, and I'm praying that Dr. Death doesn't come to my house.
Tell us about Dr. Death, Steve
Dr.
Williams.
Dr. Death, the four-time All-American. In fact, the last man collegiately to win the All-American honors in both football and wrestling.
In the same year.
In the same year. One of the greatest athletes ever. For the past few years, has competed in Japan. Is a legend all around the globe and is going to make his World Wrestling Federation debut this Monday.
Oh! A version of a flapjack there, I guess. Face first for Pierre. And Edge now in control. Scoop slam. But Edge now to the second rope.
But Dr. Death is going to be donning the gloves in the brawl for all. He's going to look to make his reputation and the buzz around the locker room. Everybody that's involved in the brawl for all wants no part of Dr. Death.
Yeah, he seems to be the favorite to win the thing. We'll see. Have to see what happens.
And for you fans who have never seen this man in action, it is going to be a treat. Here comes that rolling dive again.
Missed it that time. Went to the well once too often. And Edge takes advantage.
The downward spiral.
Hooks the leg. It could be in, and it is. Edge victorious over Pierre.
Here is your winner, Edge.
Impressive. An up-and-coming superstar. The real deal.
There really seems to be some pain, some tragedy behind the eyes of Edge. I'm going to work to try to find out that story. Maybe I'll have something for you next week.
Hopefully we'll learn more in the weeks to come. As Edge heads back through the crowd.
Where does he go?
Good question. No one seems to know. Folks, plenty more still to come on Shotgun this week. Dustin Runnels is in action. He takes on Double J. Will Tennessee Levy around? Plus, new tag team champions of the world. We'll show you how that all came about. And up next, we'll relive DX's parody on the nation, as well as the reaction. It was an angry one.
It was
from the Rocket Company.
Highway to hell.
Oh, please. Can you believe SummerSlam is already sold out? Can you believe that you attempted to sing?
Look at this. He's dancing on national TV.
The big bell.
Val Venus in the house and the ladies love him. I'm still trying to figure out what this video means.
Well, it's symbolism, shall we say.
Okay. And Val Venus now set for action this week against Poppy Chulo. Kevin, look over to the right. Carl Sagan's in the house.
Yeah, astronomy buffs.
Val Venus set for action this week. I'll tell you what, Val's been having some serious problems with a Kyan top.
Yeah, speaking of buff, how about underneath the sheets, as it were, with Mrs. Yamaguchi-san? And I don't want to get into anybody's dirty laundry, but certainly, I don't think Yamaguchi-san is taking care of business at home, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, great. We're going to hear from
Not
Val
enough,
now.
Not enough lead in the pencil.
Hello, ladies.
Hey, he's talking about you.
I ought to kick you.
Yeah, there's a Val fan.
You know, rumor has it that the New Jersey Devils are interested in recruiting the big Val Boski. The reasoning is because he has the big stick.
What?
To put it right between the pipes.
He's talking about hockey.
Yeah, right.
The Devils are the hockey team here in New Jersey. You know that.
Well, I sure do, but anyway, if you think he's talking about hockey, my friend, you got a problem.
I'll tell you what, though. He's going to have a problem with Kayantai. We talked about that a little bit earlier on. Can you believe Yamaguchi-san's wife?
Oh, Yamaguchi-san was beside himself. And, you know, hey, a lot of women find Val Venus irresistible.
Well, I guess so. And here's Poppy Chulo now. Off the ropes, Val misses. Look at this move.
Beautiful springboard off the second rope. Nicely done.
And Poppy off the ropes now tries to knock Val Venus down. Going to pay for it. Yank of the hair. Missed with the elbow, though. And Poppy Chulo, in order to win this thing, has got to fly.
Oh, he's got to elevate the pace substantially.
Uh-oh. Ooh, face first into the top rope.
And Poppy Chulo stepping out of the light heavyweight division to take on Val Venus here. You got to give that young man from Mexico credit. But certainly, the Japanese trio of Kayantai is going to be on full alert to be on the lookout for Val Venus. It could be any time. We've seen Kayantai strike out of the crowd on a number of occasions. Val Venus had better be watching his back.
Val Venus also on the card for Fully Loaded next Sunday night, live exclusively on pay-per-view, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, as he hammers away now on Poppy. I'll tell you what, we laugh a lot about Val Venus, nice Russian leg sweep, but this kid's a tremendous athlete. He is undefeated since coming to the WWF.
Well, he certainly is, and he makes his pay-per-view debut at Fully Loaded. How ironic. And on pay-per-view, do you think he's going to let it all hang out?
I don't know, but Poppy Chulo's feeling it now with those big right hands.
And, you know, I want to say something about what Owen Hart did to Jason Sensation this past week on Raw. I thought Owen Hart should have been arrested for what he did. It was absolutely criminal. And I hope that Jason Sensation sues the pants off of Owen Hart. He should have been arrested. That was criminal what he did.
And you heard what Jason said. He has nothing but the utmost respect for WWF superstars.
Well,
nothing malicious meant by it.
Well, he is, Jason is not an athlete. He's not a WWF superstar. He's an entertainer, plain and simple.
Hey, I wonder if Val Venus is going to be floating around on the Love Boat, the Wrestle Vessel. Yeah, the third annual Wrestle Vessel sets sail September 7th to 11th on Disney's new ship, Disney Magic Cruise. Call the phone number on your screen right there for all information. WWF superstars will be involved, including Shawn Michaels. Superstars will be involved in volleyball, autograph sessions, photo sessions. I wonder if Val will be involved in the cocktail party.
Well, it should be a very interesting time.
And look at Val now.
I'm sure you'll be stocking up on the Dramamine. God knows you get sick in the bathtub.
I want to see you on the deck sunning yourself on the wrestle vessel.
Don't worry, I'm a party waiting to happen, my friend.
Yeah. And Val Venus now in control of Poppy. Look at this now. Nice suplex. Tell you what, extremely athletic Val Venus moves around the ring quickly. Powerhouse.
Well, you gotta wonder, Michael. Kane and Mankind in cahoots, the question that was so often asked this past week. And we're going to talk more about that situation a little bit later on. But I want to let everybody know that Mr. McMahon was not at all pleased with the answer that he received from The Undertaker. No. I'm not going to repeat what that answer was, but suffice to say, he was a little bit upset. In fact, a lot upset. He's going to pursue it this Monday, I got a feeling.
And we'll hear that answer from The Undertaker a bit later on, coming up next, actually.
Boy, this is a submission hold here. This is unique.
Val Venus, trained in Japan, Mexico, all over the world. Now in control. And there's a right hand.
Really slugging away now on Poppy Chulo.
Poppy Chulo now up over top of Val Venus. Here's a big drop kick. Val now staggering. This would be a huge upset for the youngster from Baja, California. Whips him into the ropes now. Boot up underneath the chin. Wow, Poppy Chulo into a cover. Hooks one leg. What a kick out.
Boy, two and a whole bunch. Thought he had him.
Big right hands now. Val's in trouble. Here's the reversal. Whips him into the ropes. There's the big boots in the midsection. Setting him up now. Wow.
Double arm suplex. Nicely done.
Val Venus. Scoop slam. And now he goes to the apron. This could be it. Likes to climb the ropes. Could be going for the money shot here. High impact maneuver, high risk maneuver.
Can he fly all that way?
Here he comes down. Oh. He got it. Hooks the leg. It's over. Val Venus, victorious.
Here is your winner, Val Venus.
I wonder if Val's going to be making any more flicks with Yamaguchi-san's wife.
We'll have to see. Hey, here's Doc.
Walk this way and talk this way. Welcome back, everybody, to Slam Jam. Are you ready for the next WWF pay-per-view spectacular next Sunday? Fully loaded in your house. 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view. And don't forget, it's a World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view. That means you'll have a great time from the beginning to the end, and we do deliver. And what's going to be delivered to Stone Cold Steve Austin when he teams up with The Undertaker to challenge Mankind and Kane for the WWF Tag Team titles? I think Austin's going to be in big trouble myself. Hey, who else I think is going to be in big trouble is the world's most dangerous man and the 1998 King of the Ring Award winner, Ken Shamrock. He has accepted a match with Owen Hart in Owen's father's dungeon, the basement of Stu Hart. That's trouble. Recently, our cameras caught up with Shamrock as he was training. He had a few words for Owen.
Owen Hart, you want to challenge me to Stu Hart's dungeon? I know I'm out of my element, but my motto is anywhere, anytime, any place. I know it has a reputation, but I'll take on anything. And Owen Hart, any reason to whip your I'll be there. You better be prepared.
Well, I do applaud the courage of Ken Shamrock, but I don't know if it's a smart decision fighting Owen Hart in his father's basement. We will find out next Sunday at Fully Loaded. And if you want to find me at Fully Loaded, look for me real close to the bikini contest between Jacqueline and Sable. And don't forget, title versus title, 2 out of 3 falls. The Rock against Triple H, DX against The Nation, all at Fully Loaded on pay-per-view.
Still to come on Shotgun, you're not going to want to miss this one. Dustin Runnels, Double J in action.
Plus, Kane and Mankind defeated the New Age Outlaws, and we've got the footage.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Austin, Texas, weighing 260 pounds, Dustin Runnels.
So Dustin Runnels set for action this week. And here he comes.
Imagine!
Michael Cole.
Southern Star,
we're from the north.
For the greatest star of all, he's
Double J making his way to the ring to take on Dustin Runnels with some Southern Justice in his corner.
And if Double J is so great, why does he need Southern Justice in his corner?
Insurance policy, perhaps.
For someone so confident and so braggadocious, it seems rare that he would need all that backup.
Double J will be in action, fully loaded in your house next Sunday live, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. He'll take on Val Venus. And of course, the main event, fully loaded. The tag team titles on the line. The Undertaker and Stone Cold Steve Austin, can they coexist? They take on the new tag team champs, Kane and Mankind.
And of course, The Rock will take on Triple H in a title for title 2 out of 3 falls match at Fully Loaded. But this Monday, Michael, the entire complexion of that situation could change on Raw.
That's right, Rock will defend his Intercontinental title against a member of DX. Triple H puts his European title on the line against a member of the Nation. And also at Fully Loaded Double K, listen to this one.
Yeah.
Owen Hart, Ken Shamrock.
Yeah.
One-on-one. They will meet in Stu Hart's dungeon in Calgary.
What?
No more details available. We'll know more next week right here on Shotgun. They will meet in the Hart family dungeon. Shamrock has accepted the challenge.
I don't believe it.
That seems a little, seem to be in the favor of Shamrock.
Yeah, talk about stepping into enemy territory.
Tell us all about the dungeon. It's legendary.
Well, everybody knows the Hart family, and everybody knows what the dungeon is all about. And Stu Hart made that dungeon famous for taking young guys down there, taking family members down to the dungeon, and stretching them, teaching them the inner workings of wrestling, and making them submit, making them scream in agony. Owen was raised in that environment. He's going to take Ken Shamrock there.
More details on that next week on Shotgun, folks. Going to be an interesting matchup, fully loaded in your house next Sunday. And Double J now in control, swinging neckbreaker on Dustin Runnels, who has turned over a new leaf in his own right.
He certainly has, much in the same vein as Deion Sanders of the Dallas Cowboys. It seems that Dustin has seen the light and has had some recent success.
Oh, what a clothesline by Dustin Runnels. He's got to be a bit concerned, though, as he looks over to the apron. He sees Southern Justice in a Tennessee Lee outside the ring.
Well, some would say that Dustin may have a higher power in his corner, so he may not be walking into any more battles alone.
And here's Dustin hammering away now, big right hands on Double J. Looking over the shoulders now of Southern Justice as Dustin Runnels now takes control of Double J.
Boy, the action on Raw gets underway, 8:57 Eastern time this Monday on the USA Network. But it all begins now at 8 p.m. Eastern time, Michael.
That's right.
Code Red, the WWF's interactive pregame show, exclusively on WWF.com. Oh, wait a minute.
Tennessee Lee from the outside now. And don't forget, when Raw's over, it doesn't end there either.
Oh, no, we've got a post-game show as well. Code Red, beginning at 8 p.m. Eastern, takes you right to 8:57. And then immediately when Raw's war's off the air, we'll do a wrap-up as well. Code Red gets you all psyched up and prepared for Raw every week.
For all the information, go to WWF.com. As Double J now is in control of Dustin Runnels. A little help from Tennessee Lee on the outside. Double J misses with the right hand. Here's Dustin again. Big knock down with a big old clothesline.
Well, it certainly seems that as Double J goes on here in the World Wrestling Federation, he's adding more and more to his entourage. First was just Tennessee Lee, now Southern Justice in the mix as well. And that cannot bode well for any opponents of Double J.
Dustin Runnels in a little bit of trouble now outside the ring.
Come on.
And here's some Southern Justice being administered as a Tennessee Lee is up on the apron, distracting the referee. Look out!
Oh, man!
Dustin Runnels flattened. And Dustin feeling it outside. Tell you what, they've really changed their demeanor.
Well, they certainly have, and Southern Justice means business. They're all about business, obviously on the payroll of Tennessee Lee.
Southern Justice has been carrying around these business cards, simply say Southern Justice problem solvers on them, whatever that means.
Well, maybe I should get them. You've been causing me trouble for a while now.
Look at this.
Well, talk about problem solvers.
Some Texas backup for Dustin. Bradshaw, Terry Funk. It's Texas against Tennessee.
Yeah, don't mess with Texas.
And here's Dustin now taking advantage. Big right hands. So the odds, the playing field, level now. Dustin into the ropes now. Look at this.
Oh, backslide. Here we go.
Into a cover now. There's two. And a kick out.
Oh, I thought he had him.
Almost had him. And a big clothesline follow up by Double J. Into a cover of his own. There's two. Dustin Runnels gets the right shoulder up. We got to take a break.
What?
Chinbreaker that time. Dustin felt it. I got a question for you. Do we need any more evidence to prove that The Undertaker and Kane are in cahoots?
Well, what are you talking about?
I mean, it was obvious. Undertaker went into the ring and pulled Stone Cold Steve Austin away from the count, and as he was counting Road Dogg over Kane.
That doesn't prove anything.
What do you mean it doesn't prove anything?
How does that prove anything? Listen, until I see The Undertaker and Kane together, I don't believe anything. I don't believe you. I don't believe Austin. Wow. I don't believe Mr. McMahon. I'm telling you, there is more to this story than meets the eye.
Okay, will you at least agree with me on this point? Stone Cold Steve Austin could be walking into a trap if fully loaded.
Absolutely. And if I were Stone Cold, oh, I've got an uneasy feeling about this one. Because think about it. The opportunity for The Undertaker is there. He's the number one contender. If he could take advantage of his tag team partner there at fully loaded, I mean, it could be a really bad scene for the WWF champion.
Can anybody trust anybody?
No. Haven't we learned that? And now the eyes of Texas are about to put some hands and feet to the man from Tennessee.
Texas past, Texas present right there. And Tennessee Lee don't like what he's seeing on the other side.
I think he's getting Southern Justice up and motivated now. And
yeah, but you notice how Southern Justice didn't venture over to that side of the ring?
I wouldn't want to cross Terry Funk and Bradshaw either.
Bulldog off the rope, set tied by Dustin Runnels. Bradshaw and Funk now in the ring, and there goes Southern Justice down. Tennessee Lee has a chair.
Wait a minute.
The referee distracted. No, he wasn't. Referee Mike Chioda saw it happen. Love a disqualification here. Dustin Reynolds will pick up the victory.
Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Turn around, turn around.
Uh-oh. Southern Justice from behind. Hammering away on Bradshaw and Funk.
Oh, man. Southern Justice is really laying it to Funk. And now Dustin Runnels as well.
WWF tag teams, take notice. Southern Justice is here.
Tag teams are going to take notice of Kane and Mankind. They're the new tag team champions.
What's going to happen this Monday night on Raw? Will Kane and Mankind be there? Will we get more answers to this question concerning The Undertaker?
Yes, Kane and Mankind will be there, as will Mr. McMahon, as will The Undertaker, as will the WWF champion Stone Cold Steve Austin.
What about Shawn Michaels?
Dustin Runnels and the Godfather in action a bit later on. The Headbangers are here.
some human oddities, plus a look at a confusing situation involving the main event and Fully Loaded.
Right, we're going to try to straighten it out, and some information in the hour. Perhaps Stone Cold Steve Austin's days are numbered. I really think that The Undertaker is going to be gunning for him sooner rather than later.
Set for action now, Bradshaw and Terry Funk, and what a formidable team this duo's made.
Well, they certainly are. I mean, the scouting report on Funk and Bradshaw, they got to be right away one of the toughest teams. Bradshaw's size, Funk's experience.
They'll have their hands full, though, and they are great. There we go again.
A little public display of affection.
He's rubbing his head like a baboon. Ryan Christopher
and Scott. That's psyching him up. That's getting the energy going.
Oh, don't come near me with your hand on my hand.
I'm not touching you.
Taylor now, dancing a little bit. He's going to pay. Oh, my. He's as strong as an ox. And he outweighs Scott Taylor by a good 100 pounds.
And I understand Bradshaw's getting ready for the next round of Brawl for All as well.
That's right. He advanced. What a knockdown of Scott Taylor. Brawl for All this past week on Lord. Scorpio advancing. Also, what about the debut of Dr. Death?
Very, very impressive. A man who, unfortunately for others in the World Wrestling Federation, lives up to his nickname.
And here's Bradshaw now. Off the ropes. Caught a drop kick by Scott Taylor. Trying to knock the big man down. Taylor sort of surprised. Bradshaw misses with the right hand. Taylor off the ropes again. Here he comes. Scott Taylor, look at the strength of Bradshaw. Caught the 214-pounder in midair. Look out, fall away slam. Great reaction to this new duo of Bradshaw and Funk.
And coming right out of the chute, Funk and Bradshaw going to take on Farouk and Scorpio. Interesting to see that Terry Funk and Scorpio will be on opposite teams this Sunday at Fully Loaded.
That's right, Terry Funk brought Scorpio back here to the World Wrestling Federation. Look at this. Nice suplex by Bradshaw.
Boy, Bradshaw is just making it look easy.
Off the ropes now, delivers the elbow to the sternum. And from behind, too sexy Brian Christopher. Boot to the small of the back. And Scott Taylor, rake of the eyes from behind, takes advantage.
The rake of the eyes will slow down any man, regardless of weight differential.
Here's Bradshaw now, double team into the rope. Double drop kick, too much now, with some momentum. Can they get Bradshaw off his feet? He does! We gotta take a break! We'll be right back!
Wait a minute!
The table dates back to the late 1800s. Now, 100 years later, it's called an heirloom. Today at Oak Express, you'll also find solid oak dining tables built to last a lifetime and beyond. The solid oak Scottsdale is just $279. The solid oak Supreme table is $526. Or the solid oak Stafford is $649. And ask about our free financing programs. Oak, the heirloom wood at Oak Express. In Appleton on West College Avenue and in Green Bay.
Back on Shotgun, and Bradshaw and Funk have taken control of too much. Hi again, everybody. Michael Cole, Kevin Kelly on a Fully Loaded weekend.
And listen to this crowd for the hardcore legend.
Just turned 54 years old a couple of weeks ago. Terry Funk slapping now Brian Christopher.
Something his daddy, Jerry the King Lawler, should have done years ago.
Is it Leg's dad, Jerry the King Lawler? Here's Terry Funk now. Wow, what a move by the veteran. And quickly back up again. What a response by this crowd to Terry Funk and Bradshaw. I still can't get over it.
Oh, he's
there goes Christopher.
He's a legend. He never says die. And I'll tell you what, I know the fans are going to be going crazy at Fully Loaded during the bikini contest.
Oh, man, I cannot wait.
Sable and Jacqueline. And think about this, Michael. Two beautiful ladies in very skimpy bikinis and the possibility of physicality.
I might be in the front row for that one.
Oh, my goodness.
Can you imagine Jacqueline Sable? A little bit of physical action. Fully Loaded in your house. Neck breaker.
Put it this way. They don't exactly make skinny bikinis with
Here's a cover by Terry Funk and a save by Scott Taylor.
They don't exactly make those things with very much sturdy material. You know what I mean?
What about what Sable said? The bikini she wore at the Slammies? Well, this one will make that look like an evening gown.
Oh, but Jacqueline's got it going on. Don't
you
forget
go,
about
girl.
That. Yeah,
oh,
that's
hey, girlfriend.
Right. I think it's going to be... There's been some nasty words traded between the two of them. And I think it's going to escalate this Sunday, the bikini contest, all part of the huge card and Fully Loaded on pay-per-view.
We are sold out, folks. There's only one way to see it, live on pay-per-view, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Call your local cable company or satellite distributor.
That should do it.
Here's a cover by Terry Funk, too, and a kick out
wow.
by Scott Taylor after the DDT.
I'm very surprised by that. Look out. Look at this. Down to the abdominal stretching now. The Oklahoma Raw. This is a pinning combination.
I'm getting dizzy. It's like being on a Ferris wheel.
So Scott Taylor.
And look at Brian Christopher now.
Brian's trying to figure out how to pry Scott out of this.
Hilarious. And finally, a rake in the eyes by Christopher.
Shut up. Not exactly going well for too much, is it?
He just told you to shut up.
He ought to be talking to you the way you downplay them all the time.
And here comes Too Sexy now, along with Taylor. The double team, Punk whipped into the ropes. And look out. Oh, my. Double clothesline.
It'd be wise for Terry Funk if he could make a tag right now.
Bradshaw eager to get into this matchup.
Oh,
and
boy.
Here he comes, the 300-pounder into the ring. What a clothesline.
Taylor did the smart thing and ducked, and now he's getting the belly to back for his troubles.
A big chop to Brian Christopher. Nobody delivers chops better than Bradshaw. Taylor into the ropes, big boot. Look at the size advantage for Bradshaw.
All the strength that's taken over.
Now all four men in the ring. And Terry Funk delivers a clothesline. Too Sexy knocked out. Look out. Here's Taylor now. The clothesline from hell.
Good Lord.
This'll do it. Hooks the leg. The version of the lariat. It's over.
Here are your winners, the team of Bradshaw and Terry Funk.
Clothesline from hell.
It's an hour-long WWF Summer Series special. Check it out. 7 o'clock, 6 central on USA. Next Sunday, they debut Sunday Night Heat.
Told you your thermostat was going to rise.
And speaking of Sunday Night Heat, what about this Sunday night? Fully loaded. Bikini time.
Yeah, temperatures are rising. And clothes could be getting shredded. Bikinis could be going all kinds of directions. Because it's going to get physical, I got a feeling, in that bikini contest between Sable and Jacqueline.
This should be great. Mark Henry to the mic.
I am the world's strongest man, and I challenge anybody in this arena and in that locker room.
Talking about you. Get up there.
Come on, Michael Cole.
To come in here and have a test of strength with me. You come out here and get some of this whooping.
The pipe cleaners you got sporting for arms, I think, could do some damage.
So who is going to accept the challenge, if anyone, of the world's strongest man?
I got a feeling I know who it's going to be.
Now listen to this crowd.
What was Mark Henry thinking? Two 400-pounders are going to lock it up in a tug of war. In fact, these two 400-pounders will lock it up Sunday night and fully loaded.
From the Rocky Mountains, the man they call Vader.
Oh, we're going to get a preview of the Battle of the Bulls that will take place in Fully Loaded. We're going to tie him up to ropes, and we're going to have a tug of war.
I'll tell you what, if the crowd is fully loaded, is as jacked as this crowd is this weekend, it's going to be a fun time in Northern California.
I'm telling you what, everywhere the World Wrestling Federation is headed is totally pumped, totally jacked up. This Monday, Raw will be live from the pond in Anaheim.
Sold out, baby.
Sold out. Then we go Tuesday to San Diego. Can't wait to get to the San Diego Sports Arena. 40 WWF superstars, the Titantron, the cameras, the whole spectacle that is Raw will be in San Diego this Tuesday.
Yeah, tickets are still available, folks, but get them now. They are flying out the window.
And with all WWF live events, tickets are available online, WWF.com. You can order your tickets right from your home PC.
And listen to the reaction for Vader.
And listen to the reaction for Mark Henry. Oh, not as positive.
Sort of like me and you stand in the ring.
That's right. I get cheered, you get cheered.
So the Mastodon Vader will lock it up with Mark Henry in a tug of war. Don't forget, Fully Loaded in your house. These two will meet Battle of the Bulls. Also, Owen Hart and Ken Shamrock. Dungeon match.
For the first time ever, our cameras will venture into the dungeon in Stu Hart's home in Calgary. We're going to witness perhaps a horrifying scene, Michael. What's going to happen when Owen Hart and Ken Shamrock are locked in the dungeon?
Yeah, Shamrock stepping into enemy territory. The special guest referee, Dan Severin. Whose side's he on? Is he going to call this thing down the middle?
From what I've been told, the Beast is going to call it right down the middle. He's going to call it as he sees it.
Yeah, but what about this past week on Raw? Ken Shamrock, Severn came out to the ring to help out Steve Blackman. After the match, Owen Hart ambushed Shamrock, threw him into the stairs. Dan Severn walked by Shamrock, looked at him, fixed his tie, didn't even offer a helping hand, just shrugged his shoulders and walked by.
Well, he wasn't dressed. I mean, he had a suit and tie on.
He wasn't dressed. He could have went over and seen if the guy was okay.
Maybe he went back to see what was the story with Owen.
It doesn't matter. I want to know what's going to happen at the Hart family dungeon. I'll tell you what.
Maybe Dan Severn was checking on his plane reservations for Calgary.
Yeah, he might have. And here we go now, with Vader and Mark Henry set to lock it up in a tug of war. Tape in the middle of the ring, the referee Mike Chioda set to start things off.
And it better be a strong rope.
And I'll tell you what, first flag over the line. I mean that you lose, so Henry's flag goes over that line. If Vader pulls it over, Vader will be victorious. Listen to the crowd.
You gotta give the strength advantage, I guess, on paper.
Look at this, Vader drawing first blood here to Mark Henry.
You gotta give the advantage on paper to Mark Henry, but the crowd, he's really seeming to fire up Vader.
Yeah, but tug of war, strength in the legs as much as the arms. Vader, a former football player, a lineman, really has those strong legs, used to balance on his feet, could be interesting.
Look at the tension in the lower half of Mark Henry. He is really straining, and he's got Vader on the move. Vader's got to reestablish his solid base.
Vader in trouble now, and here he comes. Moving Mark Henry now closer to the line. This would be a huge upset for Vader. The world's strongest man in trouble. And now Henry sinks in, and look out, it's over. Mark Henry has defeated Vader.
Look like Vader got caught up in that rope a little bit.
Here's your winner, the world's strongest man.
Henry's got the momentum advantage.
Fans don't like it too much.
Mark Henry improving each and every day here at the World Wrestling Federation.
Look out, Henry now in Vader's face.
Oh, that's a good idea. Let's rub it in.
Oh, my, here comes Vader now. Henry the way with the rights and lefts. Henry ripped across the ring. Oh, my.
A near 900-pound collision.
Oh, no.
Where's he
He's
going?
Not going to climb the ropes. Oh. Come on, Shotgun, the Godfather, squares off with Dustin Runnels.
Plus, the Headbangers take on Jackals, Parade of Human Oddities, Golga, and Kurgan.
Body Slam Fruit Drink, available in three awesome flavors. Dropkick Orange, Backbreaker Blue, and Pile Driver Punch. Collect the bottles and caps of your favorite superstars, too. Body Slam Fruit Drink, it's the drink with attitude.
Yo, Rock, you should smell what I'm cooking.
Volume 2. Experience your favorite WWF original jams. On sale now at all Sam Goody and Musicland locations and other fine retailers. Plus, 1-800-COLLECT, the easy way to save.
And by Acclaim. Step into the WWF War Zone on Nintendo 64 and Sony PlayStation. Look for Stone Cold Steve Austin on the package. Acclaim Sports, sweat the details. And by Skittles, bite-sized candies.
I'll tell you what, the human oddities aren't bite-sized.
No, they're certainly not. Two big oddities right alongside Jackal.
What is this? You gotta be kidding me. What in the world?
What's she hiding under that shirt?
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, accompanied by the Jackal and his parade of human oddities.
That's what I said.
At a combined weight of 709 pounds, the team of Golga and Urga.
Hey, there's five of them in there. Jackal could be the coachman of the basketball team.
You've already got the basketball.
Ladies and gentlemen, wretched refuse of society.
He's talking to you, Michael. Listen.
The Jackal has adopted a new motto, and it is, give the people what they want.
For the love of God.
Nothing says a summertime picnic quite like watermelon.
They got milk.
What, a new sponsor?
Look at this.
Well, Jackal's certainly trying
to. Look at Finkel.
Oh, Finkel's in his glory.
Hey, snap out of it.
Okay, hey, what two champions of depravity in their own right? The Headbangers.
Jack.
Well, he's starved for attention.
Sort of like you.
Well, obviously, he didn't get enough as a child. And now, trying to build this parade of human oddities as a ratings grabber. Because, face it, Michael, in 1998, ratings and rating points are a very valuable commodity.
Yeah, speaking of ratings, I want to thank all the fans for once again making Raw is War the number one sports entertainment program in all of cable television. And look at the Headbangers. What is up with Mosh? A new look, I guess.
Yeah, letting his hair grow.
Tell you what, the Headbangers going to have their hands full with Golga and Kurgan. And what's the deal with Golga?
Well, Golga has that cranial facial deformity, as Jacqueline told us all, and that mask covers it. But Golga and Kurgan, one of the biggest tag teams in the World Wrestling Federation, perhaps the only team that they compare with size-wise, would be Kane and Mankind, the WWF Tag Team Champions.
And there he is, Whoa. The world's largest man at ringside. And Jim Cornette getting the lap full.
Well, I'm sure Corny loves that.
And here's Golga now backing Mosh into the corner. The Headbangers giving away a considerable size advantage here, but keep in mind, they've worked together much longer as a team. They're much quicker than Kurgan and Golga. And Mosh hammering away now. Head first into the turnbuckle doesn't seem to affect Golga at all.
A second time, same result.
Third time. Look at this.
Golga showing Mosh that that cranial facial deformity is not... Look at those bumps on the side of his head. Those protrusions, I guess, are not... That's not a weapon you could go after.
Folks, Fully Loaded in your house this Sunday night. Live on pay-per-view, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, sold out in California. The only way to see it's on pay-per-view, and it's headlined by the WWF Tag Team titles up for grabs. Kane and Mankind against The Undertaker and Stone Cold Steve Austin. And folks, coming up next, we're going to try to shed some light on this situation, but the story's getting more confusing as we go along.
Certainly is, and in my opinion, the hours of safety for Stone Cold Steve Austin are ticking away.
Golga into the turnbuckle that time.
Think about it, Michael. He's going to be stepping in with The Undertaker as a tag team partner against Kane and Mankind. Don't you think it would be very easy for The Undertaker to take advantage of this situation, turn it into a 3-on-1? If those three men get their hands on Stone Cold Steve Austin, they will systematically destroy the WWF champion.
Double team by the Headbangers into the sternum now of Golga. And Thrasher now going to roll Golga over. Quickly goes for the cover, hooks the leg, but a kick out with authority.
And Michael, I got to ask you, you were there on the site when The Undertaker left the building. What was his mindset?
Didn't say anything. The only thing he did say is, I'll see you Sunday at Fully Loaded. But he was obviously disturbed, had his bags with him, but later on he came back.
We'll show you that in just a little while. But you got to wonder, was it a setup? Was he setting the trap knowing Mr. McMahon would do something drastic to Stone Cold Steve Austin because The Undertaker left the building?
Now, we've talked about Stone Cold Steve Austin perhaps heading into a trap at Fully Loaded, but think about this theory. Maybe Stone Cold is actually the safest person in the building at Fully Loaded.
How so?
Undertaker wants a title shot. He doesn't want anything to happen to Stone Cold Steve Austin so he can go one-on-one with the champion.
That's a very good point. Oh, man, look at that.
Mosher behind, takes out the legs of Kurgan. Here's the cover by Thrasher and a kick out. And what about Stone Cold going to be on the cover of TV Guide?
Oh, that's right. Stone Cold Steve Austin certainly seen in a lot of different media outlets these days. And TV Guide, we're very proud that Stone Cold is going to be on the cover of TV Guide.
What about MTV?
Oh, that's right.
Something in the works with him and Mr. McMahon?
A little bit of clay, perhaps? Maybe we'll get into that next week.
Here we go now. Golga, elbow to the back of the head of Thrasher. Tell you what, the Headbangers been holding their own in this match as Golga delivers a shoulder to the midsection.
Well, certainly, I would think Mosh and Thrasher would have the distinct cardiovascular advantage. The longer this contest goes, they might be able to wear out the big men, so to speak. And it seems that Jackal is more concerned with his presence on camera and his oddities out around the ring than the action inside the
ring.
He's
an egomaniac.
Well, it can't be a good feeling if you're Golga and Kurgan, two very impressive WWF superstars.
Elbow move! Oh, look at that. Thrasher just out of the way that time. Quickly moved. And how can he make a tag? Needs to get to Mosh if he can. Golga trying to get to his feet. And here now comes Mosh. the fresh man in the ring. Golga misses him with the right hand. Uh-oh. Mosh in trouble. Belly to belly. Look at this. And Golga with authority. Wow.
Just drove it straight down into the mat.
Look at this.
Wait a minute, he missed.
Mosh hooks the leg. Golga missed with the splash. And the Headbangers win. What a big victory for the Headbangers. The Headbangers prove that Golga and Kurgan are indeed mortal. But now they're paying for it.
And Jackal's friend Rachel certainly making a show of herself at ringside. And Jackal now motioning to the largest man on the planet. He's getting into the ring, Michael.
Oh, no. Look at this. The world's largest man. He's got to be 7'5".
At least.
Look at how he towers over the 7-foot Kurgan. And Mosh goes for the ride.
He's bigger than Andre the Giant.
And now Thrasher's in trouble.
The size of his hand.
The world's largest man now. Slammy Thrasher down. Imagine these three in a six-man tag team battle.
Jackal's parade of oddities must be taken seriously as a physical presence.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. We're talking about the next WWF pay-per-view spectacular. And you know, the WWF was the originators of pay-per-view spectaculars. And we've never been duplicated. But those that try should be implicated. Anyway, Fully Loaded, In Your House, this Sunday, July 26th, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view. WWF Tag Team titles on the line. The deranged Mankind and the 7-foot evil monster Kane defending against Stone Cold Steve Austin, the WWF champion, and the number one contender, The Undertaker. Ask yourself this question. If you were The Undertaker, would you try to take Stone Cold out of the equation this Sunday? Or would you try to win the tag team titles if what you really wanted in life was to be WWF champion again? I think you've got your answer. And what about the Intercontinental title on the line? The Rock defending against Triple H, who was livid when our cameras caught up with him.
Listen, Croc, it's not know your role, it's shut your hole. At Fully Loaded, In Your House, I'm coming after you, and I'm going to take what you think is yours, your Intercontinental title. You want to stick your nose in DX's business? Well, now it's my turn to stick mine in yours. And when I come to do it, I'm not just going to do it in the traditional manner. It's going to be 2 out of 3 falls, Rock. That means I smack you around, beat you. They give you a minute, I smack you around and beat you again. I show the whole world who the Mac Daddy of the World Wrestling Federation is. And when I'm done, I walk out with the IC belt. And there's only 2 words that you can think of, Rock. Suck it.
Sounds like Triple H is going to take off right upside the Rock's head. And don't forget, if we're talking about taking it off, the bikini contest with Jacqueline and Sable, and so much more at Fully Loaded, In Your House, this Sunday, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Pacific, live on pay-per-view.
Still to come on Shotgun, Dustin Runnels in action against the Godfather.
And up next, we'll revisit the ending of that handicap match between Mankind, Kane, and Austin.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. In the ring from Austin, Texas, weighing 260 pounds, Dustin Runnels.
So Dustin Runnels, nice reaction from this crowd, but what a pay-per-view it's going to be. Fully Loaded.
His opponent, weighing 320 pounds, the Godfather, Okanisha.
Getting down. Well, the man from Las Vegas, who certainly has a lot of action on the street happening right now, you gotta wonder, can Stone Cold and The Undertaker coexist? The WWF Tag Team Championship, what a huge prize. If these two men could see clear of their differences, they could team up and become the greatest team ever.
Stone Cold could do the rare, the unthinkable, having the WWF Championship and the Tag Team Championship all at the same time. But can they coexist? Are Kane and The Undertaker working together? How does Mankind figure into this? What about Paul Bear? What about Mr. McMahon?
There are so many questions, Michael. We're going to have to wait until Fully Loaded to find out this Sunday. But I've got a dark feeling inside that the odds of Stone Cold Steve Austin coming out of Fully Loaded unscathed are getting slimmer by the minute.
Tell you what, you know the Godfather's going to be at Fully Loaded, the Nation with a busy night. There's Dustin Runnels now. New attitude of Dustin Runnels. Well, tell you what, it fully loaded. Listen to what the nation has in store. The Rock defends the Intercontinental title against Triple H. Owen Hart versus Ken Shamrock in the Dungeon. Mark Henry and Vader, and also D'Lo and X-Pac.
And plus, when they get out to Cali, I know the Godfather's got a lot of women out there. You know, pimping ain't easy. It's going to be a busy night for the Godfather.
And the Godfather spinning at Dustin. And I don't think Mr. Runnels took exception to that in the big right hand.
Well, there's some people that are skeptical of Dustin Runnels' conversion, shall we say.
Oh! Big old clothesline. Backs the Godfather into the rope, rips him off the rope. Now there's the drop kick.
And look at how well Dustin is moving. Dustin's dropped about 25 pounds, and Michael, I've never seen him in better shape.
The Godfather don't like it. Now he's hollering at the fans out there. And there's Dustin now outside the ring. Look out!
Well, Dustin Runnels certainly no choir boy, but folks, that's what WWF Attitude is all about.
And now the Godfather takes control with the big boots. What an athlete, the Godfather.
A tremendous blend of many different fighting disciplines. A boxer, a TIE fighter, martial arts, he's done it all. Oh!
Man, Dustin into the corner.
In fact, when the Godfather was in high school in California, set high jump records, once scored 67 points in a basketball game in high school.
And a big right hand to the midsection of Dustin. Dustin's in trouble here.
Now the Godfather controls Las Vegas. The west side is his side. There he goes, throwing up the symbol.
Fans don't like it too much. Dustin moves out of the way. Playing possum that time. Nice arm drag takedown into the arm bar for Dustin.
What a night fully loaded is going to be. The four most powerful forces in the World Wrestling Federation collide in the tag team title match. Kane and Mankind defend against The Undertaker and Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And you're going to be busy.
Oh, what a night we've got. Backstage at Fully Loaded gets underway at 6 p.m. Eastern. You never know what superstars are going to stop by. On Code Red, right after Raw this past Monday, we had Shawn Michaels and Vince McMahon. That was a great broadcast.
WWF.com, all the information you need to get your backstage pass to Fully Loaded. And what a knee to the midsection by the Godfather. And he is in complete control now at Dustin. Schooling Dustin Runnels. Oh, what a kick. We got to take a break. New York Mets.
The Godfather's been stomping away on Dustin throughout the break.
Oh, my. Big old leg to the sternum of Dustin Runnels. Here's the cover now. Referee Tim White with the count. There's two, almost three.
It's
Dustin got the shoulder
interesting up. That you would put the offensive onslaught of the Godfather on par with a team that's hovering at the 500 mark and will never, ever see the postseason.
We'll see. Wait till October. Here's Dustin now. Telegraphed by the Godfather. Caught him with a big right hand. Oh, wow. Folks, you don't have to wait to October for Fully Loaded. This Sunday, live on pay-per-view, it is going to be unbelievable.
You got to call your local cable company, call your satellite provider, and get the best seat in the house right next to being there live in the arena. That's at home, watch it on pay-per-view.
I'm going to be in the arena, front row for that bikini contest.
Oh, man. Sable and Jacqueline, are you going to try to catch a bikini top?
If they come flying, I'll be there.
Oh, you're all thumbs.
And here we go now. Dustin misses with a big right hand. Off the ropes. Look at this. He calls it the pimp drop. He calls it the pimp drop. Oh, my. It's over. Covers it up. Hooks the leg. The Godfather, victorious.
Here is your winner, the Godfather of the Future.
Well, pimping ain't easy, but the Godfather made it look easy against Dustin Runnels.
I'll tell you what, made it.